We're live. Can you guys hear me? No one's even here. I don't even know why I'm asking that. So, the live stream has begun. I really hope people join in here so I'm not all by myself. Let me see. What can I do? All right. Yay! Okay. I'm gonna watch myself do this because I'm a retard. Okay. Yeah! Oh no, don't go backwards. That's scary. Okay. All right. People better join because if you don't, I'm gonna get very upset. Am I? I don't know. Okay, so pre-14K Friday night subs Q&A live stream is now live. Join me. Pin to your profile. Yes, please. Let's pin that. I like this lighting. It's not bad. Not bad, not bad. Okay. I hope people join. I don't want to be here all by myself. I look like such a derp. Oh my God. I have like the stupidest face sometimes. Okay, I think this is all right. I like this light, this works. Okay. Zero viewers. People will join eventually, right? You better. People better join. I don't want to be here all by myself. Or I could just talk to myself the whole time. Let's see. I can't even like pre-14K Friday night subs. I can't even type. Subs Friday night. I'm so retarded. I'm so retarded. Okay. What's going on here? No, just join the link I posted just now on my Twitter. Why? I am not Kamen Rider. I don't know what you're talking about, but I'm gonna retweet it anyways. Hey, Wesley. Hey, Lynn Narwhal. Yeah, they are big headphones, eh? Can you hear me fine? Can you guys hear me okay on this? Does this work? I don't usually wear these ever. Oops. Hello. Okay, so I guess you guys can hear me fine. How's the quality? Maybe that's a better question. How's the quality of the mic on here? This is so hard to tell. A very tall glass of wine. Felt like I deserved this all week. Okay, cool. I'm glad. Thank you so much. Tonight's going well. I've had a really good night, actually. Yay! I was just at the movies with a friend of mine, actually. We went to go see this really cool Iranian vampire film called A Girl Walks Home Alone at Night. So we went to go see that. An old friend of mine, too, that I used to watch films with. He's super cool. And we've been waiting for this film for so long. I'm just so happy it finally came out here because it's been touring all across the US. So it's really nice that it finally came to Canada. I was just like, it's never gonna get here. It's never gonna get here. So I like these independent films because they're just so, I don't know, they have this certain edge to them. I think that they're just so much better than a lot of mainstream stuff that comes out nowadays. They're just limited runs, right? Yay, more people! Did I beat Majora's Mask 3DS? No, I did not. Actually, I haven't had a whole lot of time to play. But how was the Moby? Oh, the movie. Yeah, movie was good. It was really good. Wine makes everything a better night. It does make for a better night. So cheers to that. Cheers to good nights with good friends and yeah, wine. like really stressful weeks. Yeah, this is everyone deserves a glass of wine or a beer or a cider after something like that. It's been crazy, but it's been a good week, so I can't complain. I just decided to change the lighting a bit so it wasn't so like orange. I'm using one of my light boxes here, which I think actually turned out pretty good. I wanted to use the other one, but the cord wasn't long enough. So I'm gonna have to figure that out. But I'll just have this one coming from here. I think this is pretty good. So yeah. Hi Anthony. I just finished doing a WordPress and Twitter account, so just followed you over there. Sweet, thank you. I hope you guys are having a good night. How was your night so far? How was your week? Everything. Just let me know. Hi. Hi everybody. Okay, I'm just gonna send out a few tweets. So if I go silent for a little bit, just talk amongst yourselves and I will read the feed. Okay. Hey. You are a loser. Talking to my friend Alan, who can't come to the stream right now, and he's terribly drunk. You are a loser. Yes. let's see what's going on here. Yeah, thanks so much, everybody, for joining in for the live stream. This is really awesome. I've been like wanting to do a live stream again for a while because I just have so much fun with them. And for now, I can only really do Q&A live streams because I don't have my Twitch account set up to be able to actually like be able to play. Like, I want a full-fledged desktop if I'm gonna do that. I have a laptop I just got, but I don't know if it's. I mean, it might be fine if I'm doing like an indie game or something, or if I'm doing like a visual novel. Shouldn't be a problem. I just got to set it up because it has like Windows 8 installed in it, and it's terrible, terrible. Windows 8 sucks. If you like it, good for you. That's great, you know. But honestly, I could do without it. I really could. So I got to configure the laptop. Still, I haven't gotten anything else. Yeah, I haven't done anything for it yet, but I will. Well, and then I'll probably do like Twitch streams after that. But I think for now, you guys seem to really enjoy my ramblings, my drunken rambling live streams. So this could be an in this could make for an interesting night. I'll probably be on here just so you know now, probably for like a couple hours or so. I don't know how many, but a couple. We'll see. We'll see. The night is young. It's not even midnight yet, so. What's going on now? Whoa, there's like a bunch of stuff I'm missing here. No, Izuna, no slapping people. That's mean. You don't do that. I got it for media purposes. Like, I'm actually like reviewing it. Aw. Sweet. It's too bad you can't stay for long or old school, but I'm happy you're here now. I really appreciate you stopping by. Fury. Julie, what's Fury? I don't think I've ever heard of that movie before. Wesley. Oh, the color Akira manga. What? Oh my God. What did you end up finding? I want to know. I must know. I must know. No, I actually really want to get the color Akira mangas. They're pretty expensive if you want the full set, but damn, that would be nice. I can't keep up with all of this. It's already getting to that point, eh? Yay! Lexi, it's good to see you. I know you're kidding, Asuna, don't worry. I know. Yeah, I just don't even want to bother using Windows 8 Anthony. It's just like, no thanks. I'd rather stick to what I know. Yay! Matrix, you're here. This is great. Everybody's here. Sweet. Yeah, old school. I'm probably going to be doing these pretty often. Like I said, in my last stream, I think I want to do this like every other week or so. I think that would definitely be definitely be a good idea. So yeah, I'm pretty happy I get to play too. I just wish I got a physical copy of Majora's Mask. Ramo? I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing your, I can't talk, if I'm pronouncing your name wrong. Usually when we get review copies, when I started as a game journalist, I used to get like physical copies of games. Like I started working as a journalist back in 2006 or seven. Seven, I believe. Or no, six, after I graduated high school. I started with music and I did film, and then I later went into video games, and we used to get physical copies all the time, and now we only get like download copies of games. And I was like, no, I don't want to download code. I want the physical game, you know, like I collect these things. I want the physical thing. I'm gonna go buy it anyways, right? So that's how it goes though. What can you do, right? It's a little different in the Canadian press market though. Press market, the Canadian press as well. Usually, if you are a journalist based in the US, then you are going to have more priority than a Canadian journalist will in a lot of ways. And I'm sure that a lot of them are getting physical copies or things like that. You know what I mean? So it all depends. It all depends on the budget for the companies, right? Every other week sounds good. Okay, cool. I'm glad. Yay! Cool. Izuna, have you played Silent Hill for PS2? I played Silent Hill for the PS1, actually. I'm no good at those games though. Like no good. I can't do it. I suck at playing them. Like the controls for the Silent Hill games, ooh, that's already pretty difficult, but I love watching people play them. Like I really there's some horror games I can play really easily. Usually it's more like indie games. But then there's others that I absolutely adore. Like I love the genre so much, but I can't do it. I just can't. I'm just incapable of it. So I just watch other people play them and I get just as scared. I'm just like, oh my God. But I love it. It's not like watching movies where I can just like watch the scariest horror films ever, right? Like here I'm like interacting and I'm like, I would die if I was in an actual horror film. Or maybe my instincts would trigger and then I would kick back. Who knows? I don't know. Let's see what's going on here. Okay. I'm really enjoying crying. That's good. Urca. I love how you say that. Landarwhal, you're hilarious. Like start. What was it? Okay. So, what was it like starting out in journalism? How did you get into the career? I've been thinking that I'm going to set my heart on a career like journalism. Well, there are various kinds of journalism, and some people will tell you that some forms of journalism are more legit than others. That's just something I learned going to journalism school. There's full of a lot of snobs. So that's something you'll want to keep in mind if you do decide to go to journalism school. They intend to try and limit you on what you should and shouldn't do. Like, if you're going to do any kind of video stuff, that's typically just like broadcast, like news broadcast. Journalism, they don't really always acknowledge the fact that there's other forms, more casual forms, more playful forms, like with YouTube. So it all depends. Like, are you thinking of pursuing journalism in like a written format or in a video format? And I guess that's probably where we should begin because I could talk about either for ages. Sorry, I'm like having conversations and I'm really bad at multitasking. I'm really horrible at it. Okay. I'm also still coming off of this film. It was just so good. Okay, so if you missed this, I talked about this earlier. The goal line is okay. Just talking with people. Okay, what's going on here? Yeah, I see. Okay, I can't keep up with all of this. How many people are here? I don't even know. I can't keep track of this. Okay. Well, that I'm closing because that's distracting. Yay, Larry, happy birthday. I hope you're having a really good birthday so far. Yeah, that's sweet, man. I think everybody in the feed right now should wish Larry a happy birthday. I don't know what are you King Bet 123? Like are you on the feed right now? Because you said you're watching. Everyone say happy birthday to Larry, okay? I don't know how you want to be called on the internet, but we're just gonna do that. I'm like so behind in all of this. What's going on? I don't even know what's happening. I'm like missing stuff now. Okay, I got my copy of the original Monica. Play so much fun. La 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 la. Ooh, Police Knot. Snatcher, really? Shit. Snatcher is good if you're looking for like a good neo-noir there. Kojima is pretty amazing. Majin Buu. No, I don't actually really watch Tokyo Ghoul. It's not gory enough for me. I want more gore. I'm sure I hear something about how there's a more gory version of it, but I don't know. If you can clarify that, I may. But I like the premise. I just, I'm watching other things right now. I'm watching really terribly cutesy things right now, actually. Manga is better, but the anime is good. Oh, like Wandering Person. Oh, you didn't like The Room? See, I really like that one. I know it was a really big departure of the Silent Hill games, but I don't know, there was something about it. No, Vivi, I do not play Amnesia. I am too big of a wuss to play Amnesia. I'm sorry if I'm like running a little bit behind in the feed. I'm actually like I'm up to date with the feed. I'm just not actually like it's not lagging on me or anything. Yay! Thanks so much, guys, for saying happy birthday to Larry. this is hilarious. Matrix. Am I streaming this on Google too? I don't think so. And I don't think so. I don't know. It's just Google Hangouts as far as I know. I don't know anything about this sort of stuff. You guys are so nice, really. What I love so much about all of you guys is like considering like I wouldn't expect to have this many subscribers and actually have such kind comments and such informative and inquisitive comments and everyone just being kind to each other. Like that's what I want most of all is I want people to be kind to each other. I want people to be gracious. I want people to have fun and people to just kind of talk about the things they love, right? And I feel like that's exactly what I'm getting here. And I'm so thankful that I have all of you guys here. You guys make me so happy. You really do. So thank you. You are making my dreams come true. Okay. Let's see. Okay, Land Narwhal. Well, I started to write little pieces analyzing the games that I play and stuff like that. All I know is that expressing my opinion and organizing my own thoughts feels like a true passion. Good. That's really good. That's exactly what got me into journalism too, actually. Well, first, when I started writing, I was doing a lot of short stories and poetry. So that was how I expressed myself. But then I realized that I could express myself through nonfiction as well. And that was after reading some really good books on that, and On Writing Well is a really great book for that. There's another one, The Sense of Style, I believe it's called. There's just a lot of books that I became very inspired by, right? So, in terms of if you want to be a journalist, if you want to actually explore it in a written format, some of the best ways to do so are to start your own blog. Doing so on like Tumblr or WordPress. Press. I can't talk. WordPress. Any of that is very helpful for that kind of stuff. Also, just reaching out to like smaller blogs and checking to see if they're interested in having any new writers. A lot of times they will be, no matter what. So there's always places that are searching. Just don't always like don't aim for like the bigger ones. Even it was even hard for me to get to the bigger ones. Like there's no way in hell I was ever gonna be able to write for Gamma Sutra when I wanted to. I remember I was so close to writing for Game Set Watch, which I loved. Rest in peace, Game Set Watch. But then it closed, and then it's like, no. But the thing is you can't just write for a lot of these kinds of sites, especially if they're more challenging to get to. You need to find a very particular pitch that you offer them something that they don't already have on their channel. If they're just short on writers, they'll take anybody who's really interested in something like that on a volunteer basis. But if you have a bigger site, you're going to want to make a more specific pitch, whether it has to do with the the power of music in video games, or covering a very particular genre of games, things like that. Something that's a lot more niche. The more niche you can get and the tighter you can make your scope, the more, I guess, likable or more potential you could have in something like that. So my recommendation to you, Narwhal, is to just start writing on your own. Know that what you're doing is, yeah, maybe you're not getting paid for it, but that's you building your repertoire and that's you getting better on your own terms, right? Also, ask for people's opinions too and like reach out. Don't just like post and then expect people to be reading because a lot of times that's not how it goes. People won't just find you. Like, you need to actually make a push and be like, hey guys, look, I just started this blog or, doing so on Twitter or on Facebook or wherever. Try and get some input from people and then reach out to people. If you find anyone or any blogs that you really enjoy by like smaller blogs and stuff, reach out to them and be like, hey, I really like the work you do, but don't I say be gracious a lot because the thing is I think that sometimes people feel like they have the privilege to say, oh, well, I'm checking out your blog, so how about you check out my blog? I don't really like that, and it just I don't find it to be a very effective way of getting people to check out your blog. I think it's kind of a gimmicky way of doing so. I don't think it's a very genuine way of doing so, and I think one of the most important parts about being happy with doing what you love is being genuine, right? That's something that I've tried to pursue and I've tried to figure out for years now, in terms of journalism, is, you got to be genuine about what you do, and it's got to make you feel good. You can't just possibly, like expect to get all these views just because you're checking out other people's stuff and you're kind of guilting them into it, right? That's not how it goes. So that's something to keep in mind, but honestly, just blog, just write on your own terms and then expand from there and then just move on up. Keep in mind, this took a really long time for me. Like I started video game journalism in 2009, and the biggest I got in terms of writing was me writing for a corporate blog. And that was back in 2013. I think the end of 20 or the beginning of 2014 is when I left. And that was by far like one of my peak moments. That's where I was getting paid very well for what I was doing too. A lot of times that kind of stuff is word of mouth. If you want to actually get paid to do this, you got to meet the right kind of people. You got to like pick people's brains. You got to like actually reach out to certain people, even if they're bigger than you, and like after you've established yourself a bit, and ask to people pick people's brains. They really like it when you ask them that kind of stuff. But you have to be like really serious and genuine when you make an inquiry like that because people like that get those kinds of inquiries all the time. So you have to stand out in some way. So yeah, I mean, it took me years. It took me years and years and years to be able to get paid to do anything like that. So do keep in mind, it's not a very quick process. I know people who went to journalism school who are still looking for jobs after graduating. So, education is not a necessary thing when it comes to journalism, considering I was a dropout after my first year. I just pursued it myself. And just like one of those examples, but that you gotta have a very particular personality if you wanna take on that as well, right? Like for me, it worked because I'm just really self-motivated to the max. Sometimes I don't feel that self-motivated, especially when I'm really overworked. But overall, like I have this like incessant need to just do stuff. Like it just doesn't feel right in my life if I'm not productive. I'm turning into my mom more and more in that way, which is kind of crazy. I never thought I would turn into my mom as much as I do. But cheers to moms. Cheers to moms. So yeah, it's just one of those things. There's a lot of different ways to go about it. But if you ever want to PM me, or if any of you do for advice, I'll try my best to get back to you. It's a little tricky if you do PM me because I'm a little overloaded at the moment, but I want to get back to as many people as I can. So if I don't get back to you right away, I apologize, but I'll try my best. Okay, so I feel like I talked so much that I'm just missing this feed right now. I'm so sorry. I am so sorry. Yay. Ah, the completionist. I'm not cold. I just like wearing this hat because it's comfortable. Where is the fluffy puff? Oh, my cat. She's sitting on the couch right now, actually. She's just like chilling. She's like, so happy here, except she's sitting more like this. She's hilarious. She's so funny. She's like cleaning herself right now, though, so I won't disturb her. But But I know, like, she could sit beside me at any moment. I have, like, the ottoman down here, and she loves sitting on it. You could just, like, pat it, and then she'll just come running. It's adorable. Okay, so let's see what's going on here. Call them if they don't call back. Yeah, that sometimes works. Follow-ups don't always work, though. Like, even now, like, even with how far I've gotten, there are times where I'll reach out to certain people and they will not get back to me no matter what. Or if I might ask for help from people and they won't get back to me. So do keep in mind, like, I still have trouble with this myself. And I find myself to be more successful with YouTube than I ever was doing journalism. Journalism is a really hard market to take on. YouTube isn't easy either, but I think that people have their fortes in different things too. I really like writing, so I try and incorporate that into my life as much as possible. Like, I'm gonna start doing more writing soon. I'm just trying to getting in contact with people is hard. I swear, sometimes that's the hardest part. Not even the writing itself, it's just getting a hold of people. Or like, let's say you have an assignment that's been okay, and you're like, great, okay, so I just need to get a hold of this person from this company to be able to get an interview opportunity with this developer, but then they just won't even give you the time of day. It's just like, oh, I just want to get my work done. I have deadlines, you know what I mean? So it's hard, right? But don't think that it's just hard for you guys. Like, it's really hard for me too. And I've been doing this for way too long now. I mean, 2009 for video game journalism? I've been doing this for a long time. Too many. Not even that many. It's not like it's been 10 years yet. I'm gonna feel really old when it turns into 10 years, but it's been like 7, so old. Well, I guess I'm not that old. I'm turning 27 this year, though. If you are curious of my age, I just have really good genes, I guess. Cheers to that. Oh, glad you guys like this advice. I'm just trying to help as much as I can. Yay! Trick Gamer? Oh, Narwhal is just like someone in the feed right now. The beautiful Erica is here. Thank you, Zorker. That's really nice. Pain drain, you're too cute to be mean. You'd be surprised, actually. I have quite the mean streak sometimes. I can be really mean, but I'm not mean by nature, so it's never gonna happen. Well, not when you guys are around, at least. Yeah, pick people's brains. It's so important, Trick Gamer. So important. If you don't pick people's brains, then you're never gonna get the practical knowledge that you need, you know, the hands-on knowledge, the knowledge from people who are more established, who had to start just like anybody else had to. You know, like, I started just like you guys did. Like, I remember when I released my first video, and I remember after 2 weeks being so happy with 150 views for like one of my earlier videos. It's hilarious. It's just so funny, like, thinking about it now, and I'm just like, wow, like, that was so long ago, and I had these sort of these really silly little expectations. But even with my new channel, let's say, like my new channel, Sharp Objects, where I'm covering a lot more like subculture films, so like a lot of horror, sci-fi, experimental cinema, and tokusatsu, I'm only getting like 200 views on these videos, right? This is a very new channel. I only have like 300 subscribers, and I need to kind of get myself back into the mentality that this is a new channel. This is going to happen regardless, right? It's a little different when, you know, I check my main channel and I know what those expectations are, right? So it is a little bit tricky, but, you know, that's just how it goes. It's hard no matter what, right? So you don't just start out having it easy. It's never like that, ever, ever, ever. You always have to, you gotta work really, really hard. Hard work does pay off. I do truly feel that way. I know I was talking to a few friends about that on Twitter recently. Hard work does pay off. It might take years till you see that payoff, but you will see that payoff. You just have to be persistent, and you have to really believe in that dream and believe in what you feel like you can pursue in life, right? Am I getting J stars? Ooh, Izuna. You know, I'm actually thinking about it. We have an import copy at AMC Games where I work, and I was just like, oh, this is gonna be really cool. I wonder if this is ever gonna come out in North America. So I guess it is. So perhaps. Okay. Ooh, the completionist. You had a controversial video in the process? Are you leaving? You're making it seem like you're leaving. Best wishes and have a good night. Oh, or great night. Oh, okay. Well, good night. That makes me sad, but I'm really curious to see this video. Okay, curious. What kind of wines are you drinking? And heck, I started getting gray hair when I was 16. Oh, see, I wouldn't know if I'm getting gray hairs because my hair is purple and blue. So I could be, considering the kind of stuff I put myself through, perhaps. But what kind of wine is this? I don't even know. Hey, what are you doing? You're like pushing my books off. My cat is causing a ruckus over here. She would hate it if I picked her up right now. I don't know. I have some wine with a kangaroo on it. That's a horrible example, but it's really good red wine. I think it's a Shiraz. I quite enjoy it quite a bit. I think it's a Shiraz. Maybe it's not. I don't know. I'll probably bring the bottle after I'm done with this glass, just because why not? I'm probably just gonna finish this bottle tonight, or maybe half. I don't know. I don't, like I said, I don't have to be up early tomorrow. I do have to film, but I can also do a lot of filming on Sunday too. So why not just enjoy it now, right? Yeah. Okay. See, this is my logic. I've been working hard for this moment. This is why we are live streaming. This is why I'm drinking wine. Okay, what's going on here? So my fan, I was having issues. I was worried that my fan, I can't talk. Oh yay, you liked my review of Nightcrawler. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that. You know, these reviews that I've been doing on Sharp Objects are really short. They're only like 4 minutes a piece. But I don't know, I feel like I'm getting pretty good in terms of brevity. Like offering as much information about the films in a short period of time while still being able to convey my opinion about the films. Brevity is a really important thing to me, and I feel like I'm getting better at it. This definitely, do keep in mind, like when I do these reviews, definitely does take some scripting. Like if you want to be as focused as I am in the videos that I do, like there's no way I could do it without some kind of a script, right? Like I do a bit of scripting and improvising. I tend to improvise a lot, but filming for me is so quick now. I remember it used to take me forever to film, but now I can do so in like 30 minutes and it's all good. So the one that I do fully improvise on, however, are my weekly vlogs. So it's just practice. Practice and figuring out what you need, right? Erica, you are so bright and creative. Aw, Matrix. You're very sweet. You are very sweet. Yeah, I'm really happy to offer as much advice as I can. You know, to be honest, it's really funny. Like, I know some of you PM me in terms of advice, but I feel like it's actually faster if people just join the live streams so I could give you advice there if you ever have questions. Even here, it's hard to get to everybody's question because this feed is insane. Electro Noob, thank you for being a new subscriber. But but it's one of those things where like at least I can talk about it now. At least I can talk about it now, and I don't necessarily have to just be so consumed by all these messages, right? So this gives me a chance to offer that. And I guess, you know, at least these live streams end up getting published anyways, right? On my YouTube channel. So you can always watch it later if you want to as well. Wandering person. Yeah, I own Future Diary. I talked about it in one of my past weekly vlogs. Really, really enjoyed it. I didn't enjoy it as much the second time around, I'll be honest, but I really enjoyed it. You know, it didn't offer as much of an impact for me, but I still really enjoyed it. Izuna, is this your first time playing Majora? No, I played on the N64 after playing hell out of Ocarina of Time. I was like 9 or 10 when Ocarina came out. I was just the right age for it. So I spent a lot of time. I know that if you watched my top 5 Zelda games video. I didn't include Ocarina of Time. And while I do like Ocarina of Time, it just somehow just didn't compare to me. Like, the thing is like, I know sometimes people ridicule me on my channel because they think that I'm just too much of a nostalgic gamer. But the thing is like, if I was actually genuinely just a nostalgic gamer, then I would have blown Final Fantasy VII and Ocarina of Time just out of proportion completely. You know what I mean? Like, I don't always pick the most favorite stuff. I just pick things that I know I really love a lot. And sometimes we get upset about that. Some people don't like my opinions about things, and they don't like that I omit certain things. But that's just, I don't know. There's just certain things that trigger me more than others. So it's all genuine. There's no real bias. It's stuff that hit me harder than some other things, you know? Like, making a top five or top 10 list is hard. Like, try it yourself. Like, it's not easy. I don't put an order to any of my stuff specifically because there cannot possibly be an order to any of these because they're so different from each other, right? So, yes, Link to the Past. Okay, I will say, in terms of the Legend of Zelda games, A Link to the Past is definitely one of those games that I, is one of my favorite Legend of Zelda games, if not my favorite. It probably is my favorite, actually. And this isn't just because it was my first. I'm not saying this with rose-colored glasses or anything like that, or rose-tinted glasses. I don't even know what the saying is for that. it's one of those games that's really held up well over the years, I feel. If it didn't hold up well, I'd be a little bit more reluctant saying something like that. But I actually do genuinely feel like it's held up really nicely. So, Paindrain, I wish you were more full of nostalgia, but I am. That's the thing, is like, watch my channel. Like, I am so nostalgic, but I'm also not biased about that opinion. So, I think a lot of the people on the feed there can tell you that. I just look at my retro game collection. Just look at, like, watch my vlogs. Like, you'll see just the way I talk about retro games in general, just like being a kid and playing these games, just experiencing these things, experiencing the music. Like, I'm nostalgic at heart. It's just that I have a more practical opinion about a lot of these things too. What the heck are you talking about, Pufferfish? This whole time I was talking about, okay, what are you talking? Okay, so you just said you were a Final Fantasy VII Ocarina kind of gamer, right? No, I'm saying the opposite. I'm saying that, no, I'm saying that I'm just like, I played them, but they weren't as impactful to me as other games in either series, right? Like, Majora's Mask was a lot more impactful for me than Ocarina was. I just felt like it was a lot more atmospheric, kind of dealt with a lot darker themes. And then we're talking about the Final Fantasy series. While I did like the dark themes in Final Fantasy VII, I was looking more for something traditional in scope. That's why I liked Final Fantasy IX so much. That's also kind of why I liked VI so much, because I had that feel, but it was also very different at the same time. Like, it's just the very, it depends on the kind of experience I was looking for, right? Aw, well, it's nice having you, Trick Gamer. Thanks for stopping by. Bye bye. What kind of what more nostalgia do you need, Paindrain? Give me examples here. Like, what do you want from me, man? People, some of you guys are really funny on here. I quite enjoy this. That's another thing. Keep in mind, if you ever want to pursue YouTube, you gotta take everything with a grain of salt and just laugh through it. Laugh through it, because that's, you know, if you can't laugh through life, then what can you laugh through? You know, you gotta have fun. You gotta enjoy your time. If you take everything to heart, you're never gonna enjoy life, and you're just gonna end up feeling hurt all the time. I have to deal with that way too much for me to really feel like it's worth it anymore, right? It's I just got to a point where I'm like, fuck it. Like, that is like my motto now or something. Like, I'm sorry for the coarse language, but seriously, fuck it. It's one of the best pieces of advice I can offer. You know, you just, you know, pursue what you love in a passionate way. be kind to people, be gracious, and just don't always take things to heart. Will I dance for you, Electro Noob, when I'm sufficiently tipsy? Probably not. Because you know why? You want to know why? Because I'm lazy. And I have been working all day, all week. So no, I will not dance for any of you. But I will do a live stream with all of you. So I hope that's enough. So funny. I'm like backtracking through these just to see what we got here. What? 8-bit Eric? He popped in. I had no idea. Oh my god, he's totally here. Oh man. Hello. I've never spoken to you. I don't even know if you're here anymore, 8-bit Eric, but thanks so much. Your channel blew up quick. Yeah, it's doing pretty good. I'm quite pleased. I'm hoping that tonight's live stream will help me get to that 14K little milestone. So we'll see how that goes. But yeah, really awesome to have you here. I think you're a really awesome guy and super inspirational. So yay! This is great. Oh yeah, you totally are here. Hello. Okay. So I'm going to like go down to the bottom. I'm sorry if I miss you. Let's do this. If I don't answer your question, try and put it in the feed again and maybe we'll see it this time. So, I'm really sorry. I don't have moderators. I'm doing this by myself. So, hey, Erica, send me a new sub. Thanks for hanging out. Ah, thanks Red Tears. It's nice to have you here. Thank you, Pain Drain. Yes, I need to go through. Yeah, I'm really happy, Wesley. Vagrant Story is so good. So one of the best parts about working at ANC Games is the fact that at my job, I get to greet customers and I get to talk to them about video games all the time. This is like such a nice little part-time job to have because the rest of my life is just schedules, schedules, schedules. It's all about working. And yeah, I get to talk about video games here, but it's work. Over there, like, I feel like I'm relaxing and I'm talking to people about games. And I talk to people a lot about games, like, games that didn't receive the kind of love they deserve, like Vagrant Story, especially in terms of the fact that the game was, like, terribly cut short, just like how Xenogears was cut short. Like, I mean, like, think, like, Disc 2. You know what I mean? Like, in terms of finances, it's one of those things where, like, it didn't get the financial support that it deserved. Neither of them did in that sense. But they're still extremely reputable, ambitious games in their own sense. Vagrant Story is super grindy, super weapon-based, but so good. I love it. I love it. Yay! Thanks for still being here, Eric. Okay. Moosh, what RPGs are you looking forward to most this year? I am looking forward to Tales of Zestiria, but I'm especially looking forward to Persona 5, which I'm sure a lot of you are if you are Mega 10 fans. I'm definitely looking forward to that one. I feel like I haven't played a Shin Megami Tensei game in a while, so I was thinking, like, which one can I play next? Like, I feel like I should play one. So I was thinking about replaying the Digital Devil Saga games again. I think that would be really good because I really love those games and I like cyberpunk stuff in general. So I think it would be a really good thing to start with or to go back to. Let's see. Erica, you were asking what I found earlier from the Captain. Oh, sweet. Captain Marvel Origin, Monica. I don't know too much about Marvel. There's very few things I know about Marvel. I remember reading Civil War and House of M, and I followed Runaways extremely, like a lot, like avidly for a good long time. But I don't know too much else. Wait, have you ever read Next Wave? You would love it. No, I haven't read Next Wave. Maybe link it to me on Twitter, and then I will check it out. You know what I really want to read in terms of comics, though? I really want to read Spawn. Spawn is one of those series I never really got into, but my friend Jared, I was hanging out with him the other night, and he was showing me the sorry, I was or he was showing me the animated series that was on HBO in the 90s. I was amazed, absolutely amazed. The voice acting was great, the dialogue was great, everything about it, the mood, I was so impressed, and it just made me want to start reading it that much more. It kind of reminded me of my love for Grendel. I think it was, yeah, I think it was Grendel. I really enjoyed that a lot too growing up, but I never really got into Spawn. My ex Brad was super into Spawn. Yeah, Grendel. My ex Brad was super into Spawn, but he never really like gave me a reason to want to pursue it that much. So yeah, Spawn is sweet. I like the dark premise. I like the story. I like how smart it is. I just like really intellectual reads, whether it's in comic form or in movies or whatever kind of medium, right? It doesn't matter if it's intellectual and some, it doesn't even always have to be. Like, I really like trashy films too, like trashy B films and things like that. I could always go for a trashy horror from the 80s. Like, I just went on a binge where I bought this one really amazing one called Chopping Mall from the 80s. It's amazing. It's so good. So I'm not always intellectual. Sometimes I like things with bad taste. You want your turn-based back? Well, you'll have it back with Persona, don't worry. Persona series is great, or just like the Shin Megami Tensei series is great for that because they're so strategy oriented. They're super challenging. Every move is essential. Like, you need to know what you're doing. You need to strategize that much more. I don't usually recommend the Shin Megami Tensei games for beginners in the JRPG genre just because they're pretty brutal. You know, I'm not saying that like starting hard is bad. To be honest, that's maybe a good thing actually. That means your expectations will be high regardless. But at the same time, like, that's a lot to take in, especially if you're thinking about the bestiary in general. That is a lot to take in. Usually when I don't know, I'm just like coming up with my own stuff now. But usually if I ever recommend JRPGs or JRPG series to people who have never played before, of course I'll say Final Fantasy. But I'll also say the Dragon Quest or Dragon Warrior series. That's really incredible for that kind of stuff, I feel. Especially if you're looking for a very consistent series. It's probably one of the most consistent series I can think of in terms of that. You can say the same for Shin Megami as well, because it's always dealt with much more supernatural themes, right? Brian, I haven't actually played my copy of Type Zero, which I know is super sad. It's really sad, actually. I got my PSP unlocked, but then the patches were taking forever, and I was at this point in time, my laptop, I had to wipe it completely because I had a virus on a Mac, no less. I didn't think you could get viruses on Macs, but you can. You can, so I had to wipe everything. So I had to, I don't even know where those files are. They're on some flash drive somewhere. I'm a little disorganized sometimes. So usually I'm pretty organized though. I'm getting a lot better at it. Spawn is still around, really? Damn. That's crazy. But at the same time, like, isn't that a little bit tiring after a while? Like, if there's a series that's been going on for so long, like, how do you keep it fresh? That's what I want to know. Is like, how do you keep something like that fresh after so long? You know what I mean? Like, there's some series that can do it really well, but Hey Duncan, have I played Monster Hunter? Yeah, I have. I played a bit of Monster Hunter. Freedom Unite, I think it was, and then four, was it? I think it was four. Yeah, I think so. I don't play them all that much, to be honest. Like, when it comes to JRPGs, I tend to gravitate more towards my turn-based or action hybrids. Like, I know that that is an action, but I'm thinking more of like more controlled action RPGs, like the Tales of series, or even like the way that Final Fantasy XII incorporated action with turn-based, or Rogue Galaxy is another really great example on the PS2 for that. There are certain ones that I will forever love. There are some that I'm not as keen on. Like, while I know a lot of you probably really like the Kingdom Hearts games, I wasn't too keen on the gameplay, to be honest. I felt like it was a little bit too haphazard for my tastes in terms of action RPGs. But that's just me. You know what I mean? So, yeah. In terms of Monster Hunter, I don't really play them all that much. I need more substance. I need more story if I want to feel, driven to go that far, right? Air physics simulator. Yeah, right. They're gonna have the craziest hair ever. Eventually, they're gonna get past that uncanny valley. They already are, to be honest. They're doing it really well. Like, it's kind of amazing to see how realistic these characters look, and their hair is getting more realistic, and that's scary. They're just gonna be like real people eventually, and then it's just not gonna be a fantasy anymore. I love how it's like Final Fantasy. It's like, yeah, it's not really fantasy anymore, though. It's changed a lot over the years. That's why I'm not as keen on the Final Fantasy series anymore. I'm not saying it's bad. I actually really liked certain parts about Final Fantasy 13, for instance, or the Final Fantasy 13 trilogy, right? And I am looking forward to 15, but not to the same extent as I was for like the older Final Fantasies. So. Yeah, Puffer, Final Fantasy 12 was really good. I really like the gambit system in that. I like the hunts. It did get a little bit overwhelming. This was a point where I think that the Final Fantasy series did start transitioning into like those more outrageously huge boss battles, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. There were some pretty big ones in like older games, like when you think about like Ultima Weapon in Final Fantasy VIII, that was pretty brutal. So was Ozma in Final Fantasy IX. That was pretty brutal. Doomsday. Doomsday that shit. You gotta have Vivi on your team. You got to. But I don't know. It's kind of like blown out of proportion in my mind in terms of boss battles, but it was a really good game, yeah. Real looking stuff scares me. Yes, it scares me too, Pain Drain. It scares me too. Cars, yeah, it's definitely, yeah, Narwhal, you're totally right. Final Fantasy 15 is not really a fantasy, but neither was Final Fantasy 7 when you think about it, you know what I mean? I don't even know, like, even Final Fantasy 6 was more like, I don't even know what you would call it. It wasn't totally fantasy, it had like something else, some other stuff in there too, you know? Ozma equals kill me now. Ozma wasn't that bad. He was just like this giant floating marble that sucked. But then when you beat him, you got a card. You know what sucked more in Final Fantasy IX? When you started the game and you had to do the jump rope thing so you could get, I think it was the tiger paw. Yeah. That was pretty brutal. Pretty brutal. It's like I remember when I started playing the game. And I was like, I just wanna have fun and play this, and I'm a kid, and yeah. And then they laid that jump rope game on me, and I just wanted to be good at it. But Vivi is just like, he doesn't have legs. He doesn't have leg. I don't know what his body looks like under his clothing. I don't want to think about what Vivi's body looks like under his clothing, considering he's really cute with his clothes on. But can you imagine him without them? Like, that's really a thing of nightmares right there. I have no idea how we digress to this. Oh my God, I'm horrible. Yeah, so no, that was pretty mortifying. And then later on, I actually did go and had the patience to be able to get through that stupid mini game of death. You want, let's see. Surrealton, I want another Final Fantasy Tactics. Me too. I would really like that. I like the Advanced series, but they were a little bit too lighthearted for me. I think I just had a little bit too much. How would I say it? I don't know. I was just like, I was exposed to that melodrama. I think a lot of us were of Final Fantasy Tactics on the PS1. It was so melodramatic. It was so political. I loved it though. It's like, I'm not really a political person. I'm pretty neutral when it comes to any of that sort of stuff. But man, I really enjoyed that. There was so much political intrigue, and it was just like, it was so much drama. It was like watching The Young and the Restless or something, you know? There's a trope of fantasy being all Knights and Dragons stuff. I think six at least holds the title, but yeah, six does, except it has mechs, which was pretty interesting. There, it had a lot more technology infused in it, you know what I mean? what's going on here? Okay. This is such you, Izuna. You have like the funniest questions. I love those. Did you like the Goron race or race on the N64? Yes. I did. If you mean like Ocarina of Time or just like any of them, like I don't know, like they were cute. They made like cute noises when you talked to them. I really enjoyed them. They were super lovable. Although I will say, Majora's Mask will always, in a way, still give me nightmares, especially like when you put those masks on and you see Link's face and he's just like, he looks mortified. He looks like he's in real pain when he puts on every single one of those masks. I think the Zora mask in particular, he genuinely looks like he's in pain when he's putting it on. And I'm not surprised. I mean, his body is transforming. And can you imagine if like your whole facial structure is changing and your like height is growing like at such a rapid speed, you're like mutating way too quickly for your own good. You really should not survive that, but if you're a Link, you survive anything. Yeah, so I don't know. Yeah, Lewis, Jeanne d'Arc. It's really great. Not to offer too much of a spoiler here, but I did talk about it actually in my top, I think it was my top 10. Yeah, for my top 10 PSP games or PSP JRPGs. Jeanne d'Arc is really hard. I guess it's level 5. But it's really good. So good. Dauda Dia? Hi. Hello. Yes, I am a Dark Soul player. Not as avidly as I used to be though. But I was really good at, do I want to call it cheating? No. Although I was that kind of player where I would just shoot arrows and then I'd hide and then I'd shoot arrows and then I'd hide. And it would take me like 2+ hours sometimes to beat a boss, but it would happen. It would eventually happen. I was just like that kind of player. Horrible, horrible, horrible. What? Oh man, I almost spilled my wine all over myself. Final Fantasy V is getting remade. That's the one with the job systems, isn't it? I think that is. Hey, Pyro. I think it is. I'm pretty sure. Five, I definitely didn't spend too much time on, now that I think about it. Some of them I didn't. Like Final Fantasy III, I didn't spend a whole lot of time on either. The ones I spent the most time on were Final Fantasy IV, Final Fantasy VI, VII, VIII, IX, X, and XII. Yes. And Tactics, if you want to count like sub-series. Wasn't Bravely Default just a glorified remake of Final Fantasy V? I think it was a good homage to the genre. I know some people will ridicule it and say, well, it's basically a Final Fantasy. You could say so. It's not like it does anything original by any means. It doesn't have the most groundbreaking stories, and those characters are pretty not groundbreaking. But it's a really good game because of the fact that it reignited our passion, I think, for turn-based RPGs, because I felt like they were starting to really go under after a while. But I felt like that kind of brought that nostalgia bag. It brought back the appeal of the genre itself and showed people that, hey, you know what? People actually really want this, right? Pyro, do I play any Call of Duty games? No, actually, I do play shooters though, don't get me wrong. I haven't played in a long time. Okay, so I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of a history in terms of me playing shooters. So when I was a kid, meaning when I was 16, I used to have LAN parties with my very good friend and her two brother-in-laws. We did LAN parties for Unreal Tournament and Counter-Strike. And that's really where I got started in terms of shooters, which is a really great way to start. Oh, so good. So good. I had such a good time with those. And then later on, you know, I was playing like Halo 2, Halo 3, Halo ODST, King of the Hill is like one of my favorite modes. And then I played a lot of Battlefield Bad Company 2, and I played a lot of Gears, especially Horde mode. In terms of third person, but they're all shooters anyway. But yeah, Call of Duty, I never really got into so much, but I do have some experience. I do want to play Counter-Strike Global, was it Global Strike? I want to play more of that. I can't remember the name, but I'm like so clumsy with my hands in terms of that now. I have good reflexes, but I have better reflexes with like older games than I do with newer games, I've noticed. Like I'm pretty bad. I'm pretty bad. Like, you know, give me a beat 'em up or something on, like, I don't know, let's play like Streets of Rage 2 or like Turtles in Time, let's say, and I'll rock it, right? But give me like a new Call of Duty game and I'll suck. I'll be so bad. You guys will just totally pwn me. It would be brutal. Good JRPGs on the PC. Anachronox is a really good cyberpunk one that I own. I'm hoping I can do a review for it actually. I think that'd be really great. Izuna. Yeah, I didn't mean Gears of War. I really like Gears of War. I liked playing it co-op in terms of campaign. I cried in Gears of War 3 actually. I really got invested into that game and I loved Horde mode. Beast mode was pretty fun too, but I liked Horde mode. Yeah, woo! Streets of Rage. It deserves it. Music is incredible. Incredible, incredible. Narwhal, what is the most story-driven FPS you have played? I generally want to find an FPS with a strong and deep narrative. Does such a thing even exist? You could say Spec Ops: The Line is actually a really good example of that. If you're looking for something that's very much like Apocalypse Now in vein, or like I guess Heart of Darkness, if you're talking about the book. That definitely is a good example of that. There's that, I mean, you'll find this in any genre, really. Like I was so surprised when I started playing the Ace Combat games and I realized how narrative driven the games were. I never realized that. I thought that they were just like flight simulators. Like I did play some flight simulators growing up, like Descent, but it's one of those things where like I didn't realize just how far it could go. So I think that you can find that kind of stuff in just about any genre. It's just a matter of finding it. So that I would definitely recommend playing. Yeah. Oh my God. Puffer. Ace Combat has like such good music. Such good music. I have Ace Combat Zero on hold right now. I'm still playing through five. I haven't had very much time to play, but I'm really enjoying it a lot. I hear the what is it? Ace Combat Assault. Like I hear they're not very good. And the Ace Combat series now has really changed a lot, I hear. I hear that it's like free to play and it's much more co-op driven or like competitive, which is a bummer, but maybe that's more of what people want. I don't know. I have no idea. Let's see. I wish I knew how to pronounce your name. Christophorus? Or Zurastrophorus? I'm so sorry. Okay. What was the most disappointing JRPG you ever played to completion? Oof. To completion, that's a little tricky. So I was gonna say that what was it called? There was one on the PS3 that I wasn't too keen on. Let me see if I can figure out the name. Time and Eternity. I was really disappointed in that game because it had like a lot of potential. If there's ever a game that I will be extremely disappointed in, It won't be because I'll just say, oh, it sucked. It's going to be more because of the fact that I felt like something had a lot of potential and then it just did not meet that. And it didn't meet that by a lot. And Time and Eternity is kind of like that. Time and Eternity tried to offer a lot and not actually deliver, in my opinion. So there's that. I'm pretty pleased with all the other JRPGs I got, though. I can't really think any of any on the top of my head that I really was disappointed in. No. I actually really like Ni No Kuni, to be honest. I will admit with Ni No Kuni, I don't think that level 5 did a very good job with AI that time around. Like I felt like they did a really great job with Rogue Galaxy, but for Ni No Kuni, it was really unbalanced. Like no matter how much you tried to command your characters to do particular things, they still kind of did their own thing. Like if you would tell them, well, don't use so much magic, they would still do it. And it's like, what are you guys doing? I'm trying to strategize here. I'm trying to provide tactics here, but you're not listening to me. So that was kind of frustrating. But I'm a big Ghibli fan, and overall, I really did enjoy the game despite some of those frustrations, right? Kragox. Do I play any visual novels? Yes, I do, actually. When I'm not doing YouTube and working at AMC, I also work as a community manager for a visual novel game developer here in Toronto. I will not disclose who because why not keep things up in the air and leave a sense of mystery in my life, right? But yeah, I do play visual novels. I want to play Steins Gate actually really soon. I've been listening to the opening for that for so long, the visual novel opening. Oh, it's so good. And then let's see. I really like hybrids, like in terms of like the Zero Escape series and Big Fan. And then I'm gonna get Ever 17 here as well. Part of the Infinity series. I only have the middle one though right now, but there's that. Also Higurashi, Umineko. Even though I know like the visuals for Umineko is so bad. The hands, the mitt hands. That's basically what it is. But yeah, no, there's a lot that I've dabbled in and then ones that I have yet to dabble in. So that's probably what I'm gonna do. If I'm on Twitch more, I'm gonna be doing visual novels, I think. So yeah, Diego, Guilty Gear does have a really nice soundtrack. I'm actually super stoked to play more of the new game, as I haven't been able to rent it out because we don't have any copies at my work. But once we do, I'm gonna rent it out and play the hell out of that game because I really enjoyed it a lot. Because I really enjoyed BlazBlue as well. So I want to get good. I want to get good. I'm one of those people where I get really competitive with fighting games, and like all my coworkers at ANZ are super competitive. So I'm just like, I gotta play, but I gotta get myself a nice fight stick. And I gotta, you know, like that's how I play. It's how I do things. That's just more money out of my pocket. The mystery's over. Eric is amazing. End of discussion. She's not fully clear yet. Yeah, I can't though. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not actually supposed to disclose what company I'm working with anyway. So, like, we're just gonna leave it at that. In terms of the company I work with, for community management work or community management, yeah, work for, but it's fun. I like visual novels a lot and I really appreciate the mandate for the company I'm working with. Oh my God, yes, Lewis, Super Mario RPG is so good. I really love that game. I miss that game. I remember also playing Step Mania and having, I remember playing like one of the songs, but it was like a custom song. I spent way too much time with that. I don't know, that didn't really go anywhere. I can't talk today. Let me hold on just a second. It's like the forest song. It's so good. I wonder if Gino will ever come back. I hope Gino eventually comes back. Gino was such a badass. Oh, you're Asuna. Okay. Let's see what's going on here. Izuna, do I like the Saw movie? Not really into them, no. Pufferfish, favorite soundtrack from any medium. Ooh, Chrono Cross. Chrono Cross is like one of the prettiest soundtracks ever. Like ever. Xenogears is very close, but man. But that's just for video games. If I'm gonna talk about best soundtrack for, let's say, like a movie, that's hard. I could say Blade Runner. I really like atmospheric soundtracks. So maybe that. I don't know. That's debatable. I'm really happy my fan is working properly right now. It was malfunctioning earlier, that's why I wasn't sure if I was gonna be able to do the stream tonight. Matrix, heavy metal. Do you mean like the magazine heavy metal? Because my ex Brad, he collected the magazines. I really love them. I like that epic fantasy illustrations. I think they're just so freaking cool, so amazing. And I mean, sexy babes, you can't go wrong. Especially because of the fact that they're just like so empowering and they're just so cool and. Don't touch because you'll have to finish it, vibe. It's pretty short, time and eternity, to be honest. So. What? Duncan, really? Ringabel from Bravely Default has the same voice actor as Shinji from Evangelion? No way! Those voice actors, they have so much variety to them. It's great. Yeah, the East games do have really nice soundtrack. That's why I have my laser disc, even though I can't listen to it. This is why I listen to this stuff on YouTube, and then I'm like, oh, I'll own the physical things even if I can't listen to them. Oh, don't worry, Brian. We did mention Super Mario RPG. Someone did. Someone mentioned. I don't remember who. Man, Izuna, you have a lot of questions for me. I'm not really into the Infamous games. You should know by now what I'm into just watching my channel. Although I will admit I have offered some surprises to some of you, I think. There are certain things I disclose more than other things. Lynn Narwhal, you're going to Con Bravo, right? What usually goes on at that con? I think this will be my first convention that I go to. Con Bravo is actually a really good first con to go to, I'll be honest. It's not too big and it's not too small. When I went to my first con, like it was super small. So it was really nice. Last year I did a panel on getting started on YouTube with a couple other really awesome YouTubers. I'm probably gonna see if I can do that again this year. I might even see if I can get myself like a little table or something. We'll see. But I definitely want to get more and more involved. But Con Bravo is really great, especially if you're looking for people who are YouTube personalities or just video producers. They're really great for that. If you're looking for a good retro game community, that's a really great place for it too. It's very sorry. It's very like retro game oriented. And very video producer oriented. So that's kind of where that really inspired me to go as far as I did with YouTube, to be honest. That's really what inspired me to. It was the Retroware TV guys that were like, wow, okay, you guys are super inspiring. I want to do what you do. And so when I started, I just kind of followed that and then I sort of branched off and went into my own direction. As I realize like what works and what doesn't. Right? So yeah, honestly, go to Con Bravo. I highly recommend it. Highly recommend it. Oh no, what's going on here? This is okay. I'm like starting to fall behind here. What's going on? Yeah, the Dragon Quest 8 soundtrack was really good too. Diego. Yeah, Brian, I should come to Dragon Con. I really want to, but I can't, I don't really have the money to be able to do all that kind of stuff yet. I hope eventually I'll get to that point. Especially with everything that's going on with Patreon. My Patreon's doing really well. I'm already $600 a month. Just like monthly donations from people, which is just incredible. So I'm like trying to offer as much as I can in return, just because everyone's been so supportive and amazing. And ad revenue doesn't really provide you with that much, even with where I am right now. Like it's okay, it's not bad, but it's definitely much more donations that help me do what I'm doing right now and really help me in terms of providing myself the budget to do what I do. Because it's a kind of a funny little thing. It's like a little bit of a conundrum where the bigger, what I notice at least, is my expectations for my channel have gotten higher because I am getting bigger, right? So I want to get bigger and better for you guys. Like even looking at this live stream, I know for a fact I want to get a webcam. No, I have a webcam somewhere. I don't know where it is, but I have one. But I need something nicer, you know, like it's just not clear enough for me. Or just like even me getting my soft boxes here, like I needed that for lighting for consistency's sake. Even though sometimes soft boxes offer a little bit too much blue light, which is a little bit troublesome too. But yeah, it costs more the bigger you get, which is really funny. So like I need to get myself an external mic. Once I reach $650 per month, then I'm gonna try and get an external mic for myself. And then I also need to spend money on getting new art commissions. I have a friend in mind who I'm thinking of getting art commissions for, in terms of just changing my banner up, because I really want to. And I would love to do like new t-shirt designs since I've kind of retired mind bit, so I realized that I wanted to brand under my own name and not under something else. And I also want to do like stickers. I think it'd be really fun because if I go to cons, I want to provide you guys with stuff so you can represent if you want to, or if you like what I do and you want to support, right? But then I also have a zine I'm working on right now too, is another piece of merch, something that's really personal to me and something I've been wanting to do for a while. So there's those kinds of printing costs as well, which I actually have finalized with a friend of mine who's a printmaker. So I'll get to work with him directly, and I'll get to watch him do the process too. But then there's also business cards that I'm getting done through Moo that will showcase more of like cosplay side of things. I don't really talk about cosplaying, but I do a bit of it every now and again. I'm actually working on a cosplay right now with some friends. We're gonna be doing Oh My Goddess. So I'm gonna be doing school from Oh My Goddess, you know, in like considering the three of us, like I best fit schooled, so it's gonna be really, really fun. It's gonna be really good. But yeah, so I want to showcase all the different facets of what I do, but it costs money. It costs a lot of money, and then being able to afford rent and being able to live in Toronto is not easy. So, $650 too much? Well, I'm already at $603 per month. So I mean, I just need to go a little bit further, and they'll be there soon. You know what I mean? So I just want to be able to make this. Maybe some of you think that I'm being silly with this, but in my mind, like this is a business. Like I actually have registered myself as a business. This is like I'm taking this very seriously. This is something that I feel like in today's day and age, especially with the way that or the direction we can go, thanks to technology, I feel like the ability for jobs like this is totally possible, right? So it's all a matter of working really hard and making it worth it to people who are viewing what I have to offer. You know what I mean? So to me it makes sense. It's viable as a business, right? Let's see what's going on here. Who's this? Buying an expensive camera is overrated. I wouldn't necessarily say that. I wouldn't necessarily say that. I mean, like, my camera is a Canon Rebel T3i. I really love it actually a lot. I used to use a point and shoot. I also use a webcam, but there's something really nice about being able to upgrade, and it's not about being overrated. Like, you don't necessarily need that, but this is me giving back to you guys, you know? Like, this is me upgrading just like how a business grows too, right? So it's super important for me to be able to be able to upgrade and make my videos look as good as possible for all of you. This is, I don't know. I want it to be appealing, and I want to offer as good of content as I can. I'm a huge advocate of just like bettering myself, and through that, like that can come in several different ways. But this is my interpretation of it, and this is how I want to do it. So I want to make it visually appealing while also not worrying about like sacrificing quality of content either. Oh, LOL. America, you can do anything and get paid for it. That's funny. Duncan, do I eat a lot of instant ramen? No, but I go out for like actual nice ramen because there's a few really nice ramen places around here. I don't really go out too much. Like, I tend to try and be as cost effective about things. Like, I buy a lot of organic produce, and which is a little on the pricey side, but not too bad. I try and eat as healthy as I can. I make things in bulk so I don't have to spend so much, but you know, it's tricky when you live in the city. It's expensive regardless. Pufferfish, what is your quest? Are you talking to me? What is my quest? My quest is to better myself, like actually better myself in terms of my business. In terms of just life goals, in terms of just me in general. Life is about learning. That's just how it is. Life is about learning and just getting better at the things you do. Woo! I clearly need to fill my glass of wine. I've been staring at it for a while now, and it's just like, you're too empty. You're too empty, and it's only one. This is no. Would you guys want to stay on here for another hour or so? Like, what do you think? I'm curious. I'm thinking probably another hour and a half. After that, I think I'll split. Maybe I'll figure out some more YouTube video stuff that's gonna be coming up. I wanna tell you, maybe I'll tell you. I'll tell you after I get my glass, okay? Yay! Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna be savvy and just fill my glass really high, but not bring the rest of the bottle with me because I don't think I need to drink an entire bottle of wine by myself. I have pretty high tolerance. It's like my Eastern European side of me that luckily I have, but I'm gonna do the savvy thing and just have this. Oh no, there are some really ugly Canadians out there, pain drain. Don't you worry. Look at that sexy television. Isn't it? It's huge. You should have seen me and my friend Ori carry that damn thing. Oh, Ori is so lucky right now. Actually, a few of my friends are super lucky right now because they're at MAGFest. I am so jealous. You have no idea. So jealous. Yeah, Duncan, quit flirting with my tea. Izuna, stop asking me stuff like, have I seen White Chicks? If there's one movie I hate in this world, it's White Chicks. So, no. I like things that are. How do I put this? I don't even know how to put this. Like, I like bad taste stuff, but that's just a whole other level. No. Have I ever played RuneScape, Pyro? No, actually, I haven't. I have not, but I have definitely been interested in doing so. Yeah, I will be a bit tipsy by the end of this. Oh, I'm definitely getting more talkative, and it's getting a lot easier to talk. So, because earlier when I started, I was just like, it's kind of quiet. I always get a little bit more talkative. When I or more chatty rather. Yeah, I was it's funny though, speaking of talking to yourself or anything like that. I was talking to my boss today about how I'm getting really good at talking to myself on camera. And I asked him, I was like, is that like bad? Is that bad? Because like I could just talk on camera like I'm talking to a person. So does that kind of close me off? From talking to people? Does that make me feel like I can just be alone and be totally introverted in music? It's not necessarily a bad thing, but it's definitely good if you kind of have a balance between the two. And I totally agree, you know, and I'm really happy in terms of the fact that, yeah, I can, you know, talk on command and not have to worry. Like it's like an inner monologue going. But I do have conversations with people, though what's really funny is when I'm very different when you talk to me in person because I'm a lot more of a listener and I'm very careful about the words I use. Whereas when I'm talking like this, I just kind of talk and talk and talk. Sometimes people, when they meet me, they're like, you're quiet. I'm like, yeah, I'm quiet. I'm pretty quiet, actually. What size is the TV, JPA? It's big. I don't know how big, but it's big enough. It's good. You don't want to see the back of it. It's really bad. But it's definitely a very big television. It's great for retro games. So it doesn't blow up the image or anything either. It's a good CRT. Len Narwhal, I'm nervous to find out what kind of drunk person I would be. Have you never gotten drunk before? Noob. See, that's how mean I can get. But I didn't actually mean that. Yeah, I'm gonna sleep like a baby, Kragox. I'm gonna sleep like a baby tonight. It's gonna be so good. Just trying to catch up. I feel like I missed a bunch of stuff here. Aw, thank you, RetroCast. Appreciate it. Kahal Asama. Kahal Asama. I will tell you right now that when I started YouTube, I was horrible at talking to the camera. Absolutely horrible. Go back to my first videos and see how embarrassing I was. I don't often encourage people to go to look at my old videos, but sometimes I'm like, you know what, just do it. You're gonna do it anyways, so just do it. And I'm like, here, let me give you a little dose of what I was like back then. So instead of being like super conversational like I am now, I would just be like, oh, hi everybody, this is Erica Sabo. I hope you're doing well. I hope you had a really good weekend. Today I'm gonna talk about some of my favorite video games on the film blank. So yeah, I'm really happy that you're all here. It's really nice to have you all here. Thank you so much for your support. You see, like that, it's so funny to think back because I think my natural voice just started coming out and I was like, oh well, I guess that's just what happens. I don't know. I got more casual and I became more of who I actually am. I was just scared. It was more nerves than anything. It's not me not being genuine. It's just more the fact that I was genuinely scared to be on camera. I did not think that it was something I'd be capable of doing, right? Oh, Rick, thank you. Greetings from Canada. You guys are talking a little too fondly of my television over there. I don't know if my television appreciates it. Diego, you know. That's exactly like your first videos. I don't cuss so much on camera. It's funny, there's certain friends I have where I swear like a sailor. I think I do that with my roommate Yuki, actually. I swear so much. But then sometimes I don't. I'm just, I don't know. It depends on the person. Oh my God, Pyro, that's really bad. Stay safe, okay? Like, stay in your home and I hope everything's gonna be okay. Duncan, how old am I? I'm 26. I'm turning 27 in June. I'm old. I'm really not that old. You're as old as you feel. That's what I tell myself. Maybe that makes me in denial. But I'm going to be honest. When you get older, it really, like, I know people who are in their 30s who act like they're in their early 20s. So it's like, it's all relative. It all depends on how you feel like you should, or like, you feel, how old you feel you are, right? Like, there are certain people who are so serious, and they're just like, yeah, I'm gonna act like I'm 40 when I'm 25 because I feel like it, because I'm old. It's like, no, you don't have to, you know? Like, when I'm 30, I'm probably gonna act like I do now, and that's okay. So, yet I can still be mature if I want to be. I can be serious if I want to be, so. Aw, Christian, thank you. That's really sweet. Greetings from Canada. Yeah, Duncan, I think I got it from my mom or something. I have very good genes, I guess. Yeah, Pyro, like, seriously, stay in your home and be safe, please, please. Azuna, too mature can be an okay thing. It can just make you seem a little bit more, like, pompous, I guess. Yeah. This has been a good night so far, guys. Thank you so much. It was so much fun. I was having so much fun doing these. So it looks like we have 56 people watching right now. That's pretty good. That's not half bad. 58 viewers, actually. Imagine, I'm 19 and a tortured soul. You poor thing. No, like, really, like, I'm not joking here either. Like, I don't, like, really tortured? Really? I don't think your life is that bad. It can't be. Come on, man. Seriously. I know that when I was 19, I definitely felt that way, too. But don't worry. Things will start simmering down as you get older if you let it. Thanks, Lewis. Like I said, you're as old as you feel. I don't really know how old I feel. That's the problem. I think maybe the thing is, okay, so I will be honest, like, I don't act anything like I did in my earlier 20s, even like a year, 2 years ago. I act very differently than I did then. I can still be silly and everything, but I'm super cautious. I'm a lot more savvy in terms of like relationships and things like that. Like there's a lot that I got better at, and there's a lot that I'm much more cautious about, and it definitely wised up a lot, right? But overall, like it's like my fun-loving self that's always gonna be there, no matter what, right? What do you think, Electro Noob? I think I've made it pretty clear whether my glass is half full or half empty. I'm pretty good at playing devil's advocate with that kind of stuff, but you know, to answer your question, yes, I'm a really optimistic person overall. At the same time, I'm a very reasonable person and I'm very practical, so I don't always have like high expectations about certain things. A lot of times I do. When it comes to relationships, I tend to have high expectations and I get disappointed pretty easily. But I'm working on it, you know what I mean? I like being optimistic. There's a time and a place. Lettuce is crunchy water. Pain Drain, you are a genius. Lingerie for TVs, eh? Perhaps. Whoa, Casper. Yes, I have noticed you. Aw, why am I your senpai? Don't worry, I would notice you even if you didn't put all those emoticons. Ah, sweet, Limit Breaker. Thanks for being here. Happily, Aaron and Dodger are wicked. I'm gonna be doing another. I'm gonna be guesting on another manga pod soon, actually, for Aohoraido. That's gonna be really good. I'm excited. That's gonna be coming up in February, so stay tuned for that. Pyro, your dog is watching. Hey, doggy. What kind of dog do you have? I really like dogs a lot, actually. I like animals. I don't know. I love animals. I don't think I could ever have a dog personally. I love my cat too much. She's so adorable right now, sleeping. She's just the cutest thing ever. But I really love dogs. And if I'm ever in the company of a dog, I just like roll around on the ground. It's good. Xenodark, hello. What anime made you want to get into anime more? For example, I watched DBZ as a kid and thought it was cool, but it wasn't until I saw Yu Yu. Yu Yu is so good. I became an otaku in training. Well, my first was Sailor Moon, but that was before I even knew what anime was. I didn't really know what anime was or what like what any of that was until I was a bit older. So I think it was Slayers. I believe it was Slayers, or maybe even like Fushigi Yugi. When I watched those, I was like, whoa, I didn't even realize I was like 14 or so. I didn't even realize what I was missing. But it was one of those things where it's like we were getting them on VHS. VHS is so expensive. At the time, you're getting like three episodes. You're paying so much for each of them. It's crazy. But yeah, it was probably one of those ones, I would say. They really made me realize how much I love the medium. And then they made me realize that that's what you call it, anime. I could never figure it out. I used to ask people all the time, like, so what do you call that art style where they have like the really big eyes? No one knew what I was talking about. I think everyone thought I was crazy or something, but I wasn't. Get my cat on camera. She's sleeping right now. Not right now. My cat's name, Little Lena, is Kagero, which is actually a character in Ninja Scroll. She's not very ninja-like though, even though like Kagero was like wicked character in the film. But she's a cutie. She's black and white and has the cutest little pink nose and yellow eyes. And she comes over here. Hi, girl. Hey. You wanna come over here? You wanna say hello? Oh yeah, look, she's gonna come. Okay. Hello. Oh, she's gonna be so angry at me. Hello, say hello. She's like, Mom, why are this? I don't think she likes that. Will you forgive Mama? She forgave me. Will you sit next to me and sleep? Okay. I think that's it for her. She's like, yeah, never again, mama. Never again. She's like purring up a storm right now. VHS is your high school too, Christopher? Yeah, too much. So much. I remember my friend had like the whole Fushigi Yugi set. Oh my god, I'm like watching the feed and watching the video delay right now, and Kagura looks so upset. I'm so sorry, sweetheart. And yeah, VHS were expensive. I think that my friend paid like 200 for Fushigi Yugi. Just like the box set, it was crazy. I remember paying like 40 for each VHS sometimes too. So it's like it's kind of weird because when you think about anime now, it seems pretty expensive, right? But you're getting way more episodes than you did before. So when you factor that in, it's actually not so bad. But at the same time, like if you're paying for things with your own money too, like that's a totally different thing altogether. Also depending on where you're living too and the kind of money you're making, right? So there's a lot involved with that. The cat glitched my screen. Death Note was pretty good. I like the manga for it, but I stopped reading the manga after you know what happens without offering any spoilers. Yeah, IVGN's awesome. I met James actually. He signed my copy of Faxanadu on the NES, and he signed my tall can of Walling Rock, which I drank beforehand. Don't worry, I actually drank it. I didn't preserve it and ruin it. Even though Rolling Rock is really good. Yeah, he's really cool. He's nothing like he is on camera though, which is really interesting. He's like such a modest guy. The place I work at, ANC Games, they work together with him actually quite avidly, and so they teamed up for the Toronto screening for the Angry Video Game Nerd movie. So you can get signed posters at my work for $20, which is awesome. Like, so tempted to get one because I went and I saw the screening and it was ridiculous and hilarious and outrageous and just fun. It was plain fun. But then he was also at ANC back when we were at our old location. He was doing like signings and pictures and stuff. So that's where I got to meet him. And that was back in 2010 or so. That was a while ago. But yeah, he's really cool. I think I started following him back when he was still like the Nintendo nerd. My nose is so itchy. Okay. Okay. Kagero, stop purring. No. I know you're happy. We're all happy. Do I like baby metal? No, Rick, I don't. People are funny. After that happens. Yeah, Brian. I'm sorry, Brian. You're making all the faces. Baby metal. Baby metal is strangely interesting. It's fun. It's definitely a strange. I'll give it that. I like it for its obscure appeal. A lot of things in Japanese culture I admire for their obscure appeal. Like there was a video I posted with like a girl group that teamed up with Kiss and they did like a music video together, and it's weird. It is so weird. But you know, whatever. It reminds me of my days with like DMC. Yeah, good times. Oh no, Christian. You gotta like, okay, if you want to preserve your console boxes, you need to put them at the top of shelves so your dog can't eat them. Because like my cat, she loves chewing on the corners of boxes. She's horrible. So I just hide everything at the top of my shelf so she can never get to them. No, Izuna, I don't like Justin Bieber. Is it Justin? I don't even know. All I ever hear is Bieber. Bieber, Bieber, Bieber. Why do you think I have such bad taste? Funny. This is funny. I had to do a PowerPoint about ecstasy today, and my friend was dead set on putting Blue's Clues references in, and we were joking about the handy dandy notebook being a death note. I used to watch Blue's Clues, even though I was too old for it. I ha actually had like the dog, and you would push his stomach or her stomach, I guess, and then she would like make all these noises. I was like so old, I don't even know why I had it. I think my parents were just like, oh, whatever, she'll like it. Oh my God, Vivi, I love Cronenberg. I met David Cronenberg actually. He was doing an exhibit at this really awesome place called TIFF Lightbox here in the city that I was actually just at earlier tonight for a movie screening. He's incredible. I think my favorite films by Cronenberg are, I really liked Crash, Videodrome, and Existence. Just to give you a little bit of an idea, I think he's really awesome. If you check out my alt channel, Sharp Objects, you're definitely gonna hear a lot more about like Cronenberg. Actually, I'm gonna encourage all of you to do that. Like, check out my, if you are interested in that kind of stuff, if you're interested in like experimental cinema, horror, sci-fi, tokusatsu stuff, like Super Sentai, Kaiju, all that. Some Kamen Rider is gonna be coming up too. It's gonna be good. If you're interested in that kind of stuff, do check out my alternate channel. It's pretty like I link it all over on my YouTube page. You'll definitely find it if you check like my about section, or even if you check the details in this video right now down below. There's a portion that says Sharp Objects. If you just click on the link, then you can get there too. So there's that. Yay, little Lena. How many people are viewing now? That is a good question. 55 people. It's pretty good. That's not bad at all. This was some, you know, I did talk about doing this earlier, but I'm not sure how many of you found out now and how many found out ahead of time or what, right? So I really appreciate the fact that all of you are here. It's so awesome. Did it hurt when you fall from heaven? You're funny. Shinta. Hi, Erica. Been watching your videos for a few months now. Really like your channel. Especially your anime reviews. Greetings from the other side of the globe from Portugal. Oh, wow. It's 6:30 a.m. Jeez, man. You have quite dedication. Well, greetings from Canada. So thanks for making it out to the live stream. I really appreciate it. Oh no! My feed has slowed down. What's going on? Grimsey, hey Grimsey, how are you? It's good to see you on here. Thanks so much for stopping by, man. Electro noob, come on, don't ask me those kinds of questions. I'm not even gonna like say what it is because I shouldn't even give that like the time of day. Oh my God. The old gen gamer cat dog is like, whoa. I haven't visited that in a while. I used to read the comics for cat dog. What was it, like Mad Magazine? I used to read Mad Magazine so much. What else for like Spy versus Spy was one of my favorites for that. Let's see. Yeah, LOL. INFP, hello. Great. I'm glad you watched Perfect Blue. I just posted a review for it, guys, if you haven't seen it. I'm really glad that you liked it. It's not an easy film to watch, but I'm really glad you enjoyed it. I posted Passive Aggressive to you about Best Buy, canceling my Majora's Mask 3DS pre-order, but myself actually replied to it. I'm kind of guilty. Don't feel guilty. They did it. That's their own fault. Did they like fix your pre-order? I really hope they did. Little Lena, say my name, say my name. When no one is around, you say. Cute. Check out Erica's other channel, it's great. Thanks, Anthony. Thanks for giving that shout. Yeah, I'm just like trying to. The thing is, I'm at this point in my other channel where it's gonna have this horrible name. Because like when you look at this channel, it's youtube.com/ericasabo. That's great. The thing is, they have this stupid new rule on YouTube where you can't have a custom name until you've reached 500 subscribers. It's brutal. So my other channel, instead of being called youtube.com/sharpobjects, it's called youtube.com/A8549 lowercase w. You know, like all this, like it's just stupid. It's like no, like no one's gonna want to watch those videos. It's no wonder they don't get very many views. You know what I mean? Like it's just ridiculous. Oh, Pyro, you live in Michigan? I used to live in Michigan, actually. Where do you live in Michigan? Sorry, there was like a lot of noise. I used to live in Hudsonville, Michigan, which is like about 30 minutes to an hour, I guess, from Grand Rapids. So, Choir Dude, hello! You have an addiction to Zelda? Well, good. That's a good addiction to have, man. Yeah, Duncan. Oh my God, I love Board James. So funny. I like the Mr. Bucket one. The Mr. Bucket one is so funny. I also like the one where it's like the tornado guy. I don't know. He looks like Taz, but he's not. He's like a ripoff of Taz. What's this mean? I'm like trying to look something up really quickly. Someone said something to me in Japanese, but I don't know what you say. I can't speak Japanese. I did take Japanese classes. I guess you do night school where I was learning hiragana, but that was so long ago, and I'm not very good at retaining languages unless I practice every single day, which I clearly have not. Speaking of Japan, my friend goes on this yearly pilgrimage where he goes to Japan every single year, and he asks me all the time, and I'm like, no, man, I can't go. No, I can't go. No, I can't go. But you know what? This time I'm gonna do it. I'm actually gonna go. So I'm trying to save money right now. So I'm gonna be really poor for a little bit, but that's okay. It's gonna be totally worth it. I'm gonna go to Japan. It's gonna happen at the end of April. But plane ticket alone is really pricey. Really pricey. It's like 12 to 1500. Just need to get that, and then I can take care of everything. I can take my time with that. But yeah, that's kind of what I'm planning for right now. I was supposed to save money, but at the same time, I know this is gonna be one of those trips I will not regret, so I gotta do it. Speaking of Japan, speaking of Japanese. Yeah, you know, Limit Break, Breaker. I've noticed the fan base is definitely a wide variety. That's for sure. Actually, no. Brian, there's like no snow here. I think it's because I live in the city and there's a lot of pollution here. We just don't really have snow. It's cold, but we just don't really have any snow that's been sticking. I feel like every single year it's just less and less snow here. If I was living in Michigan like I used to, we would get tons of snow because we're getting like lake effect weather, and lake effect weather is the worst. But we also had cars, and I don't have cars now, so I don't drive around places. Aw, Pyro, you have a Maltese Pomeranian mix. I want to play with your puppy. Okay, well, you know what? If you are on Twitter or on YouTube or Facebook or anything, send me a picture of your dog. I would love to see your dog and be like, oh, that's so cute. I would love that. Thank you. Please. Please. Like so behind in these emails. Oh, or not the emails. I am behind in my emails, but I'm behind on this feed. Lewis, do you speak a second language? Yes, actually. I speak Hungarian. My parents are from Hungary, actually. So I learned a lot of Hungarian from them. I'm not fluent. I'm like half fluent, but if I went to Hungary, I could get around pretty easily. It wouldn't be a problem. It's pretty nice knowing a second language, that's for sure. And having it kind of like embedded in you. Like I can watch Hungarian films and understand them really well. So it's just something I want to kind of work on a bit more just because I don't really get to speak Hungarian to anybody right now. Unless like I'm talking to my mom on the phone, right? Who is my bae? That's a good question, Landerwall. I'm really bad with names, which is really horrible. Because I haven't played Fire Emblem Awakening in a long time, so I can't really tell you who my husband do or waifu is at this point. I will though. I will send you a tweet with that kind of information. I think Kagero needs some lovin'. She's like so sad right now. She's like, oh, nobody's paying attention to me. It's the way it goes, cat. Oh. Hey, choir dude, happy birthday! Happy birthday! Did that work? Is that good? You want my dog nudes? It'd mean a lot to me. No. Choir dude, that's not selfish at all. And I've known you, like we've known each other here on YouTube for like such a long time. So yeah, happy birthday, honestly. I hope you're having a good day so far. Or I guess that's today. So I hope you've had a good hour and 37 minutes so far. No, I'm almost done, and then that's it. So this is it. I'm glad you like my laugh. I think my laugh gets better as I drink more. Okay, this is the last little bit. I tend to drink a lot faster after I drink more. That makes any sense. So I'm taking my time. Let's see what's going on Twitter. Happy anniversary of 20, happy celebration of 21st anniversary of living. No, Ennio, I'm not getting white girl wasted. You don't understand. You really don't understand. I actually have a really high tolerance. So just like, I don't know, I like wine, and having half a bottle of wine's quite a bit, actually. What was I drinking, Lena? It's a red Shiraz. No, puffer. I'm not getting wasted, guys. If I want to get wasted, I would do like two tequila shots straight, and then I would have this. You should have seen me actually on New Year's. I drank so much. I had like four bottles of cider. I had a glass of wine. I had a shot. I had some Bacardi. It was really hilarious. Oh, I'm glad. Yay, 21. That's a really nice way of treating yourself, choir dude. That's awesome. Allison. Yeah, all of you guys, send me your dog nudes. That sounds horrible. That makes me sound like I'm into like bestiality or something. No, send me your dog pictures or animal pictures if you want to. I'm a really big animal person. Like ever since I was a kid, I've always been a really big animal person. Just a lot of animal empathy. I didn't grow up having any pets, so I just imagined having pets. So I think my bond for them has grown that much stronger. So yeah, if you want to send me pictures, I would love to see some pictures of your awesome, incredible pets because having a pet is so therapeutic, I gotta say. Having a pet is just amazing and just makes me all fuzzy inside. See, there's like 52 people, 53 people here. That's pretty good. No, that's not true. Erica's not getting wasted. I don't know what you guys are talking about. I already drank all of the wine I will drink. You guys will not peer pressure me into this. Oh, I'm sorry, Kahala. Oh, I can't pronounce your name. You're right, Kahala. So I'm just gonna call you Kahala because that's easier. I'm sorry. Like, I actually feel really bad. The reason why I feel so bad about this is because of the fact that when I was growing up, nobody could ever pronounce my name right. Ever. Like, ever, ever. Like, even just the Z alone in my last name was just too much for people. People used to call me like Erica Szaszbo. Like going to school, it sucked, right? So don't, yeah, please. I'm sorry. Well, dudes, at least you are noticing. Raphael, I notice you, don't worry. Yeah, dogs are always nude. They are, Diego. They just are covered in fur, just like cats, too. Or other animals. They're all naked, I guess. It's kind of weird to think about. No, you're not paying for a pain drain. That's not even possible. Aww. Erica, why you leave Michigan? We got 6 inches of snow. Wow, that's crazy. Kahala-sama? Is it Kahala-sama? Oh, Kahala-chan. I see. Kahala-chan? Okay. I get it. I get it. I get it. Like I said, I used to take Japanese classes, so I had no idea. I'm sorry. First time on live streaming, love your channel. Thank you, Roaming. I really appreciate that. Thanks for being here. Yay, all the people. Okay, I'm happy. Yeah, Zabo is too hard. It's Sabo. It's actually Subbo, but my parents always pronounce it Sabo growing up. We're even lucky that we kept the Z. Most people take the Z out. Sabo or Subbo is actually a very common Hungarian last name. It means tailor, like to be a seamstress tailor. But there should be a hyphen actually on the O as well. I may get my last name changed so I have the hyphen back on just because I like things like that, the way they should be, right? But I don't know. Yay! Kahala-sama. I'm gonna say that forever now. I'm a quick learner, don't worry. Anyo, you missed my cat earlier. I brought her over here and she was very unhappy. So you'll have to check back earlier in this stream if you want to see it. Gazebo. Yes. Tetsuyo? Is it Tetsuyo? Yay! Anemobix. Oh my god, I have so many notifications on Twitter. This is ridiculous. Tetsuyo? Wait, or is it Tetsuyo? Aw, John, no, but I like your comments. You always offer such really good comments. I want you to be part of the stream. Oh my god, Daniel. Oh my god. I like this feed. It's funny. My neighbor is a drunk. He's outside. Oh my God, Pyro, stay in your home, please. Good night, Brian. Thanks so much for joining the live stream. Ah, Takio? Cool. What ethnicity are you? Let's see what all these tweets are. Oh gosh, this is gonna be crazy, I bet. Oh my god, doggies. Oh my, your pet is destroyed. Hello, kitty. Yay. I love all the animals. Oh, what a sweetheart. That's a really cute dog. Well, Jen Gamer, that's a really freaking cute Hello. Aw, these are the best. You have made my night. I'm gonna even tweet about that. You have made my night your off with your what's the right word? What's a good adjective? Your sweet animal picture. I want to meet all of your pets. Yay, I want to meet all your pets. Come join my live stream. Yeah. You made my night with the blah, 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 blah. Okay. I really hope that I get to 14,000 tomorrow. That'd be really awesome if I did. I can't believe I've already gotten to that point. That's crazy. Yay! No, don't go home, everybody. Erica-senpai favorite in my tweet. Don't call me senpai. I'm not your senpai. Oh, if you want to say. Fighting for Nippon. Hello. Hello, Daza. How are you? I haven't talked to you in a while. I missed you. Really? Choir dude? Hakuoki? Yeah, that's an otome game, isn't it? I've been wanting to play. Billy's here? What? No way. I must have missed this while I was typing. What the heck is going on here? All these people here. And I didn't even know they were here. You guys are totally on the ball, and I'm not. Clearly, I'm not. My script keeps, like, I don't know. I keep getting these pop-ups saying, "Oh, your script is, I don't know, delayed or slowed or something. Do you want to shut it off? Or do you want to like close this? Unresponsive script. That's what I'm trying to say. Do I want to stop the script? No, I do not. I will not. All right, what's going on here? Yeah, my computer's not enjoying me. I think I'm gonna stay on till about 2:30 or so. That's cool with you guys. I think I'm starting to get a little bit tired, so I need to get some sleep. I gotta film some videos tomorrow before I head to Yorkdale Mall. I gotta go there to get my MacBook checked, actually, just because I'm having a lot of hardware problems. I need to get my RAM upgraded, which I'm going to get third party anyways, but I got to get first party battery, and I don't think I have to replace the hard drive, but I do have to replace the fan, which isn't going to cost too much, but I'll need to do all that soon. We should have a 14K sub collab because I'm only 7 subs away too. Really? Are you serious, Daza? Oh my God, I can't believe that. That's crazy. Okay, cool. I think we should totally do that. If you want to collab, just like message me. And we will do a collab together because I like doing collabs. They're fun. I want to spin in my chair right now, but I know that would be such a bad idea. Yeah, that would be a really bad idea. I'm not doing that. We're not doing that. Wow, okay. So Azuna, J Star is coming to US. That's cool. That's really good. I'm happy that is confirmed. So what's going on in this feed? Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, thanks so much for sending me all of your puppy pictures and your kitty pictures. Makes me very happy. Getting some more too, it looks. Ha! Ha! No, Billy. No one's going home because they're already home. All right, what else? Tits are getting the fuck out. Funny. You guys are gonna really spice up my feed here. I used up all the topics here that I talk about in the postcard. Still got that postcard hype. Expect the team interrupts. Yeah, it'll happen, don't worry. I'm actually in the middle of writing them right now just because my weekend is free and it's been a crazy week. It's just been really crazy. I'm so actually, you know, that's another thing I want to do is I wanted to apologize for having such a weird schedule for videos. I usually don't have like my anime videos on Thursdays. It's usually Mondays, but it's just been nuts. This is my first week working in the new office for my community management work, and I do that every Tuesday and Friday. And then I work at ANC Games on Wednesdays and Thursdays. I just did not have any of this cut out for me at this point in time. Like this coming week will be easier because I'll know better. I'll know that I'll need to, you know, do a lot of filming during the weekend and on Mondays, right? But then the rest of the time I'm like screwed, right? Also like Thursday mornings I can too. But I think that the schedule will be back to normal. It's still 6 videos. I can't guarantee I'll still be able to do the 6 videos, but I'll do at least like 5, right? I'm gonna try my very, very best to get everything out there so I can get as many videos to you as possible. It's just timing. You know, time management is really hard. It's really hard. I try my best, but that's kind of why I'm happy to be able to do stuff like this too. Live streams where I can just have like casual little videos during my downtime, right? Yeah, Anthony, they are better than the browser crashing, thank God. I'm also really happy my fan is actually working right now. Before I wasn't working at all, so it's I think it's on its last leg, so I'll have to get it replaced anyways, but yeah. I'm the kind of person who has service battery, and I've had it for like almost a year now. I'm horrible. I actually feel really bad for my laptop. I really like it a lot, but it's just like it's a lot of work, and I'm not very good at maintaining that kind of stuff as much as I love technology. Yeah, bye, Diego. Thanks for being part of the stream. Whoa! Matrix. Erica, it's amazing how much you get done with everything you do. That's awesome. Thank you. It's lists. I make a lot of lists. And I set a lot of small goals for myself and big goals. That's how everything happens. That's how the magic happens. Choir Dude, how are the holidays for ANC Games? It was pretty crazy, I'll be honest. But it's usually pretty busy regardless. I work cash, so I mean, I'm gonna deal with a lot of it. But yeah, it was pretty busy. It was good though. It was really good. Aw, thanks, Anthony. I really appreciate it. Yay! Retro Liberty! Erin, you're here. Welcome. Welcome to my live stream. Thank you, Daza. Yeah, seriously, if you want to collab with me, Daza, just message me and we'll figure something out, okay? I want to do more collabs. I don't really do too many collabs. So it's going to happen. It's going to happen. Has to happen. Aw, yay. My lips were chapped. I have to put lip balm on. I had no choice. So you guys want to know like what I've been reading lately? I've been reading Video Game Storytelling. I actually got like a review copy of this book. I've been wanting to read it for a while. It's actually really good timing to get something like this. Especially because I've been upping my responsibilities and my community management job a lot. And I mean, I think you can tell how involved I've gotten in this book because of all the little stickers I put. I put a lot of stickers. I do that a lot. I like books like this. I like books on video game theory in general. So, and I'm a storyteller, right? So whether it's through nonfiction or fiction writing. So this has been really helpful for me. I definitely recommend this book. I may or may not do a review for it. I was asked to do a review for it from the company that sent it to me. So I may talk about it on like a weekly vlog. I may offer like a little segment where I might have a video where it's like a bunch of little mini reviews and stuff like that. But I do want to tell you right now, this is a pretty good book in terms of practical knowledge. Do keep in mind there is a lot of reference to Star Wars. So if you're not a fan of Star Wars, you might get a little bit ticked by it. But it's been really good so far. I'm really enjoying it. I'm only like halfway through it right now. I'm on page 81, right? Yeah, about halfway. But I definitely recommend it if you are interested in being a video game writer. I know that was super random, but I just really wanted to share it because I've just been so jazzed about that book. I'm really liking it a lot, and it's giving me a lot of just things to take into consideration in terms of game writing because I want to expand my role with the company I'm with. So yeah, there's that. I'm also learning code right now too. I found this really great site called Code Academy where you can learn all this stuff for free. So I'm learning Python right now, actually, or I'm gonna start learning Python probably this weekend, just so I can be a bigger asset to the company and just take on as many more responsibilities as I possibly can. So it's gonna be really fun. I'm excited. I'm super excited. Oh, good night, Duncan. It was nice having you here. Thank you. Oh, Izuna, are you leaving too? Bye. Oh, wait. Oh, no. Are you saying goodbye to someone else? I don't even know anymore. No, Billy. Don't say those things. You're horrible. I think it's funny. I like Aaron. This is amazing. I love this feed. I could just sit and like read it and be like, wow. Okay. This is just as entertaining, or more entertaining than me, probably. You're stealing the spotlight, Billy. Seriously. Okay, sorry, RJ Reviews. I'll repeat my question. What is the re most recent game soundtrack that you loved? Mine would be Carlo Castellano's soundtrack for The Swapper. Oh, for a video game? Okay, so for a movie, it would be for a film that I just saw tonight. That was A Girl Walks Home Alone at Night. This is a really great Iranian vampire horror flick. It was super stylish, really moody and cool. I really liked it. That was a really good soundtrack. In terms of games, like recent game soundtracks that I really like the soundtrack for Ace Combat 5. I've been spending a lot of time with that game and I'm really enjoying it a lot. So I would say that. What else we got here? Oh, okay. Then welcome back, Izuna. Sure. Pyro, just send me a private message. If you go to my about page, you'll see, you should see my email address or business email or something. I wish I could actually say what you guys are saying on this feed, but I can't. Eric, seriously. Okay, thank you, Aaron. Real talk. What is your favorite horror movie? You know, it's really funny you mentioned this because on my other channel, I'm doing my top 20 horror films of all time. So I'm going to indulge you in a few. I don't know if I have like a favorite, but I will tell you right now, one of my favorites is The Reanimator. I love that in terms of sci-fi comedy horror. I love that a lot. The Thing is a really good example of horror that I love in terms of sci-fi as well. For newer horror, Beyond the Black Rainbow is a really great film. I really love Evil Dead 2. For comedy, Wreck and Wreck 2, really good horror films. Man, there are just too many. I'm really like, I'm very curious though, because you said you were a horror fan as well. So it's just like an example of some of the stuff I really enjoy. But like, I just want to pick your brain. I want to know, like, what are some of your favorites too, because I want to get an idea, because like, everyone has their favorite sort of sub-genres in the horror genre, so yeah. I want to know. Roaming? I'm surprised that you're into. Yeah, actually, I didn't think I was going to be into the Ace Combat games. I didn't think I was going to like flight sims, but it's not just about me liking JRPGs. It's more about me really enjoying Billy, stop. I'm trying to talk. It's more about me really liking narrative in games, whatever the genre, it doesn't matter. Aw, thank you. High five. No, I won't add you on. I won't add people on Skype. I don't just add anybody on Skype, but you can talk to me on Twitter and on Facebook. So there's that. Okay, what else do we got here? These are awesome. Yeah, Matrix. I love Evil Dead. Like, especially like Evil Dead 2 was so good. So funny. Thanks, Killing. I am quite keen on some of the some trauma films, actually. Like when I'm thinking of Romeo and Juliet. Oh gosh, that one's ridiculous. I like bad taste, or like Chopping Mall I was talking about earlier too. Alligator was pretty good. There's some pretty ridiculous ones. The Attack of the Giant Leeches had a really horrible scene where I don't think that the guy realized this, but they were in this canoe. There was a guy wearing like a speedo, but I don't think he realized. I'm gonna be a little bit vulgar here. Like such a pr I seem probably seem like such a prude, but you can totally see the guy's ball sack, and it's really horrible because I don't think when they were filming, I don't know if they paid attention, or the guy who was filming paid attention to the fact that like this guy was just sitting there and you could just see his junk. It was horrible. It was hilarious though. It's actually a really horrible film, but that's the highlight of it. Let's see what else. I love Gremlins. Like Gremlins 2 in particular is so good. What else do I own that's bad taste that people might enjoy? I don't know. Too many things. Oh my god, Jack Frost was terrifying. That was so scary. It's like, hey kids, so my soul is gonna go into a snowman. I don't think I'm gonna live for very long. It's so freaking creepy. Ah, you have the Ginger Dead Man trilogy. I used to have the like the pumpkin ones, the pumpkin head ones. I think that there was more than one. There was also the Leprechaun movies. You remember like Trolls 2? Trolls 2 is like the best scene ever. If you haven't seen it, guys, you gotta like search this on YouTube because I can't do it justice. But it's just too good. I'm not even gonna say anything else than that. Puppet Master is pretty bad. Yeah, man. Killer snowmen are good. Yeah, Seven isn't really horror. It's good though. You know, it's funny, BB, you mentioned Chucky. Like Child's Play gave me nightmares as a kid. It's just no matter what, it gave me nightmares. I still get nightmares from that sort of stuff. Oh yeah, Legacy Plus for the 3DS. Yeah, that just was released, wasn't it? Woo! Rosemary's Baby. Oh, that's a really, you know, that's really funny that you like that movie so much, considering that was my first review. American Mary, yeah. Oh, sweet. Got some good taste there, Aaron. What are some recent ones you saw? I'm curious. For any of you horror fans out there, I gotta say, like, if you do hear about this film, A Girl Walks Home Alone at Night, it's really good. I definitely recommend it. What other horror did I watch as of recently? I haven't really watched any other. I mean, I watched like Nightcrawler, but that's not really horror. I watched like a lot of different sort of things. Like I'm gonna watch Why Don't You Play in Hell really soon, which is like a film about the Yakuza making a film. It's really ridiculous. It's gonna be good. And then I saw Inherent Vice, which is just crazy wacko. It's so good. In terms of horror, though, what other things? What are some newer things that are coming out that I should look forward to? I don't know. I'm not sure, actually, off the top of my head right now. Hello, Nanosphere. It's nice seeing you. I feel like I'm losing my voice. Oh no, I do. RJ, I totally do like the original, like the classics, let's say, for like Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I just like, I don't know. I like going off the beaten path when it comes to horror. That's why my other channel, Sharp Objects, is so focused on subculture. Because I like there every now and again, like classics will peek in there, like Rosemary's Baby. But it's still one of those things where it's like, I like to focus on things that maybe aren't. Maybe people aren't exposed to as much. Aaron, okay. Erica, my son just woke up, walked into the room, looked at you on screen, and said, "Why is mommy on the computer?" Yes. That's hilarious. That's so cute. You have the best kid ever. Best. You have, he has made my night. That's great. I love the classes of the classes. Dracula, Wolfman, Frankenstein, the Mummy, the Creature from the Black Lagoon, and the Bride of Frankenstein, the Big Six. Nice. You got some really good choices there. American Psycho? Cool. Yeah, see a Limit Breaker. Thanks so much for stopping by. That's great. Yeah, no, there are a lot of classics that I'm really into as well. Like Metropolis is like one of my favorites. I know it's not horror, but it's still like one of my favorites. I do like a lot of older horror as well, like the Hammer horror classics. And then there are some others, like Eyes Without a Face is really good in the Criterion Collection. It's a really good film. Let me think, what else? So many things. Now you see me? No, I haven't. I have not. I have not. What do I want to watch now? Well, since I kind of want to get back into my moody vampire fix. I would like to watch Let the Right One In again, like the original, and then Thirst. I saw those both in theaters and I really liked them a lot, but I would like to watch them again, especially now that I saw this really stylish vampire film tonight, like in a heartbeat. In a heartbeat. So I might try and get my fix. I don't really watch a whole lot of, there's certain kinds of horror that I don't really focus on so much, and vampires aren't really my thing quite so much. Unless we're talking about, oh, what's it called? Man, I can't remember the name. I'm gonna hate myself for this. Yeah, I can't remember. I know I'll remember later. I'm gonna feel stupid, but that's okay. Let me see what's going on here. We still have 50 people here. Jesus, go to bed, guys. Seriously. Starboy, Hapog, Capture, TurboGrafx-16. I actually haven't tried my rocket with the TurboGrafx yet. But I will. I'll see if it works. We'll see how it goes. Nanosphere. What are you recording the stream on? It's actually through Google Hangouts. If you go, like, all I have to do is go through like live events and then it connects me to Google Hangouts and then I hit live and that's it. Super easy. What? Dazza, you're not going to bed. You are a rebel. Such a rebel. Yeah, what is sleep? That's a very good question. You know, for a long time, I actually had really bad insomnia. My insomnia finally started going away as of late. So I'm happy. Hey. I agree. I'm hardened to horror, but I don't really dive much into vampire stuff. Good excuse me. Who else is going to eat this gallon of ice cream tonight? Ah, Aaron, you're very lucky. I wish I had some ice cream tonight. I can tell you are a big ice cream fan. I need more ice cream in my life, and I don't have any right now. So, yeah, I will live vicariously through you. Let's see. Oh my God, Mallrats. So good. Yeah, sleep is totally overrated. That's absolutely right. I worked in a movie theater for 3 months, consuming some of my popcorn and hot dogs. I don't go to the theaters anymore. Aw, that's so sad, choir dude. But that's like an experience you don't really get any other way, right? I'm too horny to go to sleep, Eric. Funny. You're very funny. What's this? Anyhow. Am I allowed to post my PSN name and Skype name on here? Erica, answer me. Answer me. It's not about you being allowed or not allowed. If you want to, you can. Just know that people may or may not troll. If you want, you can send them to me privately, but keep in mind, I don't play a lot of new games, and I'm not really on PSN that often, and I don't really accept people on Skype too often. The best ways to get a hold of me are on Twitter or Facebook if you want to chat, to be honest. Oh my God, RJ, you've seen Martyrs? Yeah, I have this film. It's like weird though. I was talking about it with a friend tonight actually, where it's just like it's split into two, and I really like the revenge aspect of it in the first part. And then the second part was really weird and just very like torture porny, and I don't know how I felt about it. Although I did like The Loved Ones. The Loved Ones is a really good Australian torture film. Like if you like stuff like this, like Saw, then you might really enjoy it. But it's more than that. Like it has a lot more that it has to offer in terms of breaking the mold of genre. So, but yeah, Martyrs was kind of scary. I have it in my collection, and I'm like too scared to watch it again. I did a review for it because I used to do like horror movie reviews, and yeah, I'm probably not gonna go back to it for a while. Mokuba, do you watch Japanese gore movies? I'll take any gore. Yeah. I like Eroguro artwork as well. So yeah, I don't really have any limits in terms of any of that stuff. Pyro, have you seen any of the Taken movies? And if you have you seen Taken 3? I haven't seen Taken 3. I've seen Taken 1, which was actually pretty good. It wasn't that bad. Pain Drain, what's your favorite slasher? I like Dario Argento a lot, like a lot. I like how stylish his stuff is. I like Italian horror. So Tenebrae is one of my favorites. But if we're talking just like 80s slashers, I'll probably say like, which one? Can I say? There's so many to choose from. Sleepaway Camp. Sleepaway Camp is pretty funny. I like that one. Pufferfish, how about Kung Fu Chinese Action? Any fan of these? Well, I really like early Jackie Chan stuff, actually. So, like, what's it called? Drunken Master? I really like a lot. Big fan. Big fan. I wish we still got stuff like that. I really like Bruce Lee as well, so anything with him. I'm very big fan of. I like martial arts films, if you didn't know. I'm a sucker for them. Anything that incorporates some sort of martial arts. I like speaking of that right now, I'm really wanting to watch The Raid 2. I really liked The Raid. I thought it was such a good movie, and I love the practical martial arts that were used. It was just like so incredible. For a while, it made me want to get into martial arts, but I don't think I have sort of like discipline in order to do so. I was actually thinking about going into Filipino stick fighting, Cali, But I just don't think I have the time to, not with the sort of schedule I have, because I have three jobs, right? So I don't think that's like in my schedule. I don't think this is gonna happen. What's going on here? Yeah, I know, right? The rate is really good. I didn't know Ergo is Barchier. I don't think I am, but okay. Christian, yeah, Gonga was actually pretty good, but I would love, 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 love to see Fincher actually create something original. It's been a long time since he has. Do I like Taken? Yeah, Taken was okay, but I've only seen the first one, Billy, so I can't really speak too much for it. Oh my God, Vivi, Audition! Audition's so good. I'm a big fan of Takashi Miike's works. He's a weird guy. He has like such a strange variety in the films he's made, but Audition's like one of my favorites. Ah, Pulp Fiction, yes. Can never go wrong with some Quentin Tarantino, that's for sure. Let's see what's going on here. I can't go through the feed. What's happening? Who's my celebrity crush? Joseph Gordon-Levitt. I would love to meet him someday. I know he just got married, but he just got married to a really intelligent woman, which I really respect. But I will forever have a crush on him ever since I watched Third Rock from the Sun. I don't care. It's gonna just be forever. He's so amazing. And I love his project Hit Record as well. I think it's really great. I like people who are that ambitious. Like ambition is one of the most attractive things for me in terms of dating someone, so that's like a factor I hold very high. All right, what music are you into? I'm into a lot of kind of stuff. Lately I've been listening to a lot of chill wave, like a lot of Tycho, Sigur Rós, Neon Indian, Washed Out. I listen to some trip hop too. Like I really love Massive Attack, Burial, Portishead. I also listen to a lot of like Outrun or Dark Electro. So Perturbator is a really good example for that. Kavinsky, a lot of good stuff. Lately, it's been those things. Oh, you really should see Dusk Till Dawn, Nano. It's really good, actually. Billy! Yes, sometimes I shop at Goodwill. Sometimes. When I go to Goodwill, I go more so to look for the systems, though. I look for cheap systems. Except over here in Canada, it's Value Village. I mean, we have Goodwill. There used to be a Goodwill that was like right outside my apartment, but it closed. So I go to Value Village now, and sometimes I find like, well, I'll find like a Genesis or a Nintendo or a Dreamcast for $20. I will take that. But it doesn't happen often enough. It depends. Do I like chips and quesadillas yearly? You guys are asking funny questions. Yes, I like quesadillas and chips a lot. Heavy metal, Shinta, yeah, I do. I like fantasy babes a lot. Yeah, Vivi, I like dark wave. I mean, I don't like it too much. It's much more like EDM, electronic body music for me. Like Mind in a Box is really good. Let's see what else. You guys are asking me so many questions. Do I play basketball? Oh, it was to you. I was like, no, I don't play sports. I used to play sports. I'm really competitive. I could probably play sports if I wanted, but I don't. Hey, TJ Mack. Hi, it's good to see you. Sweet. I think I'll be done here maybe 3. I know it's at 2:30, but some of you guys are popping on here. Have I ever thought about game developing, Renan? Yeah, I'm actually in the middle of it right now. Amidst all the other things I'm doing, I'm a crazy person who does not live a normal life, who is a workaholic, who loves what she does. And I'm working on actually a little visual novel project right now. I can't talk about because it's in the works. And if it doesn't work out, I'd rather not say I'm working on something. Okay, so suck these nuts. No! Yeah, I used to listen to Alice in Chains when I was younger. What? King Tut's mask broke? Oh my god, yeah, Nicholas. I love his works. I really like, I think he did Drive and Only God Forgives. I'm a big fan, actually. I saw Only God Forgives in theaters, as well as Drive. I really like them a lot. I like ultra violence. I like really quiet films that have like those instances of ultra violence in them. I like that transition a lot. So the reason I constantly call you Erica is that when I eventually meet you in real life, I can just scream Erica and you'll know exactly who I am. That's a really good idea. That works for me. I really enjoy it. Roaming Dan. So you're more into retro gaming than new gen? Yeah. I am. I much prefer retro games. That's why I work at AMC as well, so I can just talk about old games. I'm like trying to go through the back, but this is too much. I can't do this. This is too much. I'm trying. This feed is going crazy, you guys. I gotta get editing. Just wanna stop by and say thanks for the great work and thanks for putting us on our videos. Thank you, Erin. You are awesome. You are a constant inspiration to me. And I can't wait to check out more of your wicked videos because you also offer like a lot of really stellar videos that are just so much fun and you're just cool. I just kinda tell you that right now. You're super cool. So I can't wait to talk to you more soon. Do you have any felonies? Billy, you don't want to know. Really? Wait, Shinta, what are you talking about? Just backed Clannad visual novel on Kickstarter? What is this? What are you talking about? Are you on... Okay, if you're on like some social media thing, can you link me to that Kickstarter thing? Is that new? Like, there's no way. I need details. Yeah, Erin is cool. How do I like the Wii U? I really enjoy it. Give me the chance to play Earthbound. Yeah, I'm actually really enjoying it. I haven't picked up any games for it since I got my review code for Bayonetta. So like the reason why you never see a copy of Bayonetta 2 here is because I only have it on the system. But it's a really great system. It was actually my first current gen system. I just haven't picked up Xbox One or PS4 yet. Although I used to have an Xbox One here in the apartment and we played like Titanfall and that was pretty fun. But I'm happy I have the Wii U. It wasn't something that I really wanted at first. It didn't really seem like it was a viable console to have, but now it does. So I'm really happy I have it. You guys are making my night with your weird comments. Yeah, I was gonna say, because like the Clannad visual novel's been a while. I didn't know if like they remade it or something or what was going on. Would you rather get chased by a vampire, werewolf, clown, or zombie? None? Ennio? None of them? Oh, Project Sakai. Okay, yeah, I'm familiar with Project Sakai. They do some really cool stuff. Yeah, I have to agree with you, Mac. Nick is bringing a whole new style for art house films. I really enjoy his stuff a lot, so I'm really excited to see what else he has to offer. Vivi Dorian Gray. Yeah, I saw Dorian Gray long time ago when I saw Fall of Troy when they were still together. They were fun, but I don't really listen to them anymore. I haven't seen Enter the Void and Irreversible. Hoonie Pop? I don't know what Hoonie Pop is. Let's see what's going on here. There's too much happening. Too much. What is Hoonie Pop? I want to know. Would you rather be in the world of Harry Potter or non-muggle or be rich and famous, but have the rich and famous dispute and mystery? I'd rather live in a cyberpunk world. So, which isn't necessarily a good thing because dystopian atmospheres aren't great. Still, though, I would rather live in a place where I'm like well ahead in the future. I think that'd be really awesome. Transhumanism for the win. I could Google Hoonie Pop. I could, but I'm not going to. No, I won't. Hoonie Pop. Whoa. What do we got here? Do I want to know what this is? Dating puzzle RPG. Okay, so it's like is it like a hybrid visual novel? Interesting. Okay, I'm gonna look into this more later. I have never heard of Hoonie Pop. Erica is Kamen Rider. Alan, you are here. Hello, Alan. Hello, drunk Alan. I'm sorry. Let me correct you on that. What? Oh yeah, Vivi, Boogie Pop Phantom like freaked the hell out of me when I first watched it when I was in high school. It's like the anime progressively got darker and darker and darker, and it was just like you felt really claustrophobic when you were watching it. I really enjoyed it. I didn't fully understand it though when I first saw it, but it's pretty good. It's not a visual novel? Interesting. It just looks like a visual novel then. Nano. Yeah, actually, I have played Deus Ex: Human Revolution. I played the original Deus Ex games on the on PC. I really enjoyed them. Do I like Cicada? I haven't actually like watched much Cicada to be honest. So, but I'm aware of it. Yeah, I'm quite keen on the soundtrack for the Deus Ex games. Pyro, no, I don't play any League of Legends. My roommate Yuki does though, but I don't. What do you think of the transhumanism represented there in Deus Ex? I'm pretty open in terms of transhumanism and being like I don't consider myself a transhumanist or a futurist or anything like that. I consider myself more of a humanist than anything. Like I kind of try and focus on the present. I don't really focus so much on the future. I used to focus all the time on the past, but I've recently stopped doing that. But yeah, I'm definitely a person of the present, so I don't like I support the thoughts and the ideas and the philosophy behind it, and I do encourage it very much so. I think that we can definitely incorporate technology not just in our daily lives, but also even as a part of ourselves too. Like when you think of like amputee victims, let's say, and how you can use technology to help them live more manageable lives. You know, if I was ever in a situation like that, I would definitely want to use technology in my hands to be able to, I don't know, keep my options open. It's all about human potential for me and what we are capable of doing for ourselves and what we're. I mean, it's limitless. It's not even about what we're not capable of doing because it's limitless. It depends on your mindset at the end of the day. So, yeah, I definitely encourage that kind of stuff, but Let's see. Do you prefer Ocarina of Time or Majora's Mask? Majora's Mask. I much prefer Majora's Mask for atmosphere and for its dark themes. Ocarina of Time, I was talking about this earlier actually too. While I did like Ocarina of Time, like I grew up right at the perfect time for these games. I was like 9 years old. I remember getting EGM and having like Ocarina of Time be like the top game of all time. You know what I mean? But I really enjoyed it, but nowadays I find it quite bland. In comparison, Majora's Mask I find to be a lot more timeless in appeal. So that's just me though. Oh yeah? Good. Yeah, I haven't really delved too much into Hyper Dimension Neptunia Rebirth 2. Yeah. No, Nippon UG is a really good company. I have my copy, but I haven't really played very much of it yet. Like, I've been so busy, and I have Majora's Mask and everything as well, that I'm trying to play as much of as I can so I can get my review out in like a timely manner. But I mean, TJ Maxx, you know what it's like, the kind of demand there is being a journalist. It's a lot of work, but it's worth it. It's always worth it. It's good. It's good payoff. Yeah. What do you think in relation to transhumanism of having technological prosthetics that really support humans who have lost limbs? Yeah, I already said that. I already said like for amputee victims. I highly support that kind of stuff. For technological prosthetics for people who need them, definitely. What do I think of Star Ocean? I've really only played Second Story. I have Second Story on the PS1. I really enjoy it, so it's good. Yeah. I like better because of Sorry. Yeah, it is really hard to keep up. I know, right? There's only so many hours in a day. And when I now have a schedule, like an office scheduler, like a scheduler I'm out of my home from Tuesday to Friday, it makes things super difficult. I used to have Mondays, Tuesdays, Fridays, Saturdays, Sundays off. Or I would work solely from home. Having those 2 extra days in an office makes everything so different now. I gotta like reorganize my entire schedule in order to get all my videos ready and be able to have time to play all these video games too. So it's a lot, but it's worth it. Okay, let's look at all these Twitter notifications. Yay! Aw, kitty! Animals, so many animals. Snakes, I'm so happy. I'm so happy right now. Okay. All right. Nana, you have some funny questions. What's your favorite food? I like a lot of stuff. I like eel. I like unagi a lot. I like cookies. You want to buy me cookies and then send them to me? Let's see, what else? What else do I like? I like toast with honey. Very good. Very, very, very good. I don't know what else. Who knows? Mondays, Tuesdays, Fridays. What is this? You guys are funny. Funny. I love this. I love how you guys can talk amongst yourselves while I'm quiet. This makes me very happy. You guys are so supportive and nice, and I just feel so happy and all fuzzy inside. Okay. I'm starting to get kind of tired. La 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 la, 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 la. Leno, do you ever think about what will happen to YouTube in the near future? In the near future, it'll be fine, especially since it's been obtained by Google. I'm not worried about it at all. Not at all. It's going to go on for a long time. It'll prosper. This is one of those things where as you get older, it might be more of an issue, but I think that I can be in my 30s and still be talking about the things I'm talking about right now, and it'll be fine, and it'll be relevant. And we'll always, we'll have discussions, and it'll be up to you guys whether or not you want to keep watching, right? So it's all about you in the end. It's all about like just us talking. It's all about the community, that's really what it is at the end of the day. Unagi. Oh yes, I could definitely use some. Raphael, see you. Thanks so much for joining. Yay. Oh, I could totally use some sushi right now. RJ, yeah, to be honest, I'm definitely, probably, most definitely going to be reviewing Drive or Only God Forgives on my channel. I would not be surprised on Sharp Objects if I did something like that. That would make me really happy. Nino, Shadow Realm Universe? No, but I did pledge to the Kickstarter for Shadowrun Online. Yeah. What else? We've got to go back to the future. I want the Dragon Quest Heroes. I think it's called that. Dragon Quest Heroes. I don't think I know that. Do you think Carmen Sandiego is the greatest thief of all time? She taught me a lot about geography. That's for sure. I don't know if she was the greatest thief, though. I don't know who's the greatest thief of all time. I don't know. I actually don't know. Okay, bye bye. Bye bye, Kahala. It was really nice having you. Thank you so much. You think so, TJ? Okay, good. After Nightcrawler, Drive seems perfect. Yeah, I know, but like, I don't know. Like, I just saw this other movie. I just saw A Girl Walks Home Alone at Night. It was a really good vampire film. I really want to talk about it. I think I'm gonna review that first, and then I'll go to Drive. Oh, I don't know. There's so many things I want to do. I think I can really only limit to like one review a week on Sharp Objects, and then have some other kind of content because I can't have two reviews. Like it's just too much review-wise, right? I think that unless I'm gonna do like a double feature, I'll do like a review of Drive and then a review of Only God Forgives next week. I think I can do that. Well, not next week because next week will be okay, 2 weeks from now. How about that? This is too much, guys. This is good though. The sooner I schedule this kind of content, the sooner I can get it done, and the more likely it is I'll get stuff out on schedule too. No, I know. I know sushi isn't just seafood, or whoever said that. Ah, oh, TJ, you saw the movie? It was so good. It was so good. Yeah, I'm happy that you saw this, Amir, because I'm not sure if anyone else has seen A Girl Walks Home Alone at Night, but it was so stylish. The soundtrack was so good. I want to get it on vinyl really badly. It was just the lighting, and I think that the black and white really added to the feel of it. It was so good. It had some really colorful characters in it, and it was just an awesome film. I'm so happy. So happy I got to see it in theaters. Am I tripping? No, I'm not actually. I am not tripping. I'm just talking about things I like. So. Bronson? I have not seen Bronson, the Devil Burning, actually. I've only ever seen two of his films, like I said, Only God Forgives and Drive. So I clearly need to educate myself further. Bronson. Ref. I gotta like really enlighten myself here. 2008, eh? Interesting. Else we got? Guys, ugh. Daza says I look tired. I probably look really tired. It's been a long week. It's been a really long week, and I'm sorry if I look tired. I'm actually super excited to be here. It's been like a really long week, but that doesn't mean I won't end things yet. I'm having a good time, and this is like my chance to relax and actually do a live stream. I've wanted to do these for a while, so. Like I said, I want to try and do live streams every couple weeks, I'd say. I think that sounds about right. I look hot. Thank you. No swearing. No swearing. Jaws. You get the fuck out if you're gonna talk like that. You GTFO. Unless you're gonna be nice, then I won't tell you that. It's like Drive's younger brother, the guest, really? Ooh, that's exciting. I could do a live stream on Twitch, definitely. I'm definitely gonna upgrade, so don't worry about that. I'm like totally gonna upgrade. It's just I'm gonna use this for now until like I feel like the time is right, which will be soon. Don't worry. Oh my God, the room. No, you're tearing me apart. Yeah, I've heard good things about this. Like, you guys aren't the first ones to say that. Yeah? Okay, cool. I'll definitely check out the guest. I'm gonna type that to myself right now, the guest. Okay. Pufferfish. Watch your effing language. Izuna, no, I don't own an Xbox One anymore. I used to, but not anymore. Oh my God, the devil burning. Thank you so much for talking about the king. I just watched that actually a couple weeks ago. I love that movie. It's so good. I really like Gael Garcia Bernal. I think he's a really incredible actor, and he did such a good job in that film. It was such a good, oh, it was so good. You guys are funny. I haven't seen Frank, no BB. What's up? What's up, ref? It's good to see you. Oh, I'm getting tired. Sleepy, Erica. Sleepy. But I have to stay on here. I should probably leave at 3, guys. I'm getting tired. Daza already told me through a private message that I'm looking tired. I'm so tired. Tusk? No, I haven't seen Tusk. Why do girls hate fedoras? I don't know. Hotline Miami equals best game soundtrack. Oh my God. Yay! Thanks, ref. I'm really sorry, I'm sleepy. No! Devil burning. I'm so sorry. I'm gonna stay for a bit longer. There's still 10 minutes, maybe a little longer. I'm like starting to get all loopy. This is what happens when I stay up too late. I get really like loopy and then I'm just like all over the place. Yeah, the Hotline Miami soundtrack is actually really good. Yeah. Yay! Oh my god, you don't want to know, TJ. I like listen to the Transistor soundtrack like non-stop. But it's just such a good game. Oh, so good. Night Pyro. I'm really happy that you were able to stop by. Thank you so much. Anyway, Erica, go to bed. Oh my god, Double Dragon Neon soundtrack was so good. Double Burning was just like, so awesome. It was like good, like Outrun, dark electro music, you know? Like I was talking about earlier too. What is it? La Matos, there's Perturbator, Kavinsky, all that music. Vestron Vulture, which I now use as my new background music. Which has been really awesome and so good. He's like an old colleague of mine, someone I used to work with. But yeah, I like Outrun. I love that genre in general. It's so good. Alan, I knew Transistor was good. I just didn't get to play it until you showed it to me. I mean, granted, my friend Nick did show it to me first, but to actually be able to play it and to really get into it, like, so good. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. And I was totally missing out there for a little bit, but I'm not anymore, so. Hey, yeah, The Babadook. I actually saw a trailer for that. I'm not really into that kind of horror, I'll be honest. Like ones where it's like there's something in the house, you know, like the house is haunted, there's like this monster, you know, fill in the blanks or whatever. I'm not really into that subgenre, but my friend Mike, who's a big horror fan, was telling me it was actually pretty good. I want to check it out, so soon I will. Oh yes, Mokuba, Jet Set Radio Future soundtrack is so good, so good. The Monaco soundtrack is actually really good. Rizzy, you have good taste. I don't hear a whole lot of people talk about Monaco, to be honest, considering the kinds of acclaim it was getting. So it's really good to hear that kind of stuff. Yep, The World Ends With You is a very good DS game. I will always respect anyone who has to say that. The old gen gamer, thank you so much. That really made my night right there. Okay, what else do we have to talk about here? It's more about dread than the monster itself. Like psychological, like that's fine. What's going on here? The Guest soundtrack was really good. Cool. I'm gonna talk to some of my film friends about this. This is gonna be good. Very good. Yeah, like earlier I was talking about, because I noticed there's like a few film people here. Just to give you a little bit of a taste, I'm gonna be watching Why Don't You Play in Hell pretty soon, which is gonna be really fun. I'm really looking forward to that. And then what else am I gonna be watching? I might watch Nightcrawler again, perhaps. I'm really tempted to watch A Girl Walks Home Alone at Night again, because it's just that good. I'm trying to think of what else. I just went to this really awesome film screening that happens monthly, the Laser Blast Film Society here in Toronto, and they show like all these ridiculous films. And they showed this one that was a lot like Bugsy Malone, where it stars like child actors. It was called Hawk Jones. It was like a crime drama starring kids, and it was hilarious. It was at the Royal Cinema. It was just ridiculous. I had such a fun time. There was another film that I wanted to watch that I haven't seen, but I've heard really good things about, especially through my friend Peter. What's it called again? I think it's called, yeah, I Am a Knife with Legs. I hear it's really good. I'm a really big fan of like deadpan humor. I really like Flight of the Conchords, like really dry humor. So I'm kind of stoked about that. I'm just really hoping that I can see it sometime soon. It's just a matter of what's going to be coming out in theaters here in Toronto, you know what I mean? So. Ooh, yeah, okay, The Devil Burning. If you want to send me your IMDb movie list, if you check my about page, you'll see my email address. So just feel free to email me, okay? Oh my God, TJ, you saw that? Okay, good. I'm really glad. So you really enjoyed Why Don't You Play in Hell? I've heard only good things, so I'm gonna check that out. You clearly live in a really good area because I feel so behind in all of these films. Oh my God. Yeah, Xenoblade Chronicles 3D is gonna be so freaking good, choir dude. Okay, bye Daza. It was really nice talking to you. Have a good night or good morning. Oh, whatever time it is in Australia. Hey, brunch. Hey, this is actually really poor time though. I'm getting really tired. Why is my count going up? It's already like 53 people watching, but I'm so tired. I've been on here for a little bit now. It's almost 3.5 hours. So I might make it 3.5 just to kind of close things off for people who are just joining. But thank you so much for joining. Like, this is really awesome. And I've had a really fun time live streaming so far. So, really appreciate it. It's been a fun night. Let's see what's going on here. There's a Valkyria Chronicles anime. What, Jimmy? What? I want to know what this is. It's crazy. I'm going to have to look into this. As far as I know, this is a film blogger, so I'll try my best to look at the screen, especially if it's something that's really interesting. Yeah, TJ, I used to be a film blogger as well, actually. So I definitely know that. It's just like, oh, it's been so long. Like, I feel like I've been focusing so much on video games. I haven't been focusing as much in movies themselves. So I've been on this binge as of late, and it feels really good. Like, having like movie nights with friends and everything feels really, really awesome. So it's nice talking about that kind of stuff and revitalizing sharp objects, which. You guys didn't know, it used to be this subculture blog that I ran back like from 2009 until 2011, I believe it was, where I would cover like more obscure films, obscure cinema in general, and graphic novels. And I brought that back with my new alt channel so I can talk about films. So, yeah, making up for lost time. Cool. Is it really based on the first game, Jimmy? Cool. I really like the first game. I would like to see that very much. Aw, no problem, RJ. Cool. Thanks, roaming. I really appreciate that. I'm glad you guys actually like the fact that I just sit on here and talk and not play video games. Thing is if I played video games, I wouldn't be able to answer half your questions. I'd be like, I'm focusing, guys. I can't. Like that's what would happen. It would be really horrible. Like I just can't focus on two things at once, especially when it comes to something like that. So, yeah. Wish you can play it. Aw, Leonor Wall. All the feels. That's a really nice comment. Thank you. I'm really glad. If you ever need anything, honestly, I am just a tweet away. Or I am a live stream away. Or I am a Facebook message away, too. Okay? Yeah, like honestly, I'm just like, I'm no good if I did like if I did like video game streams, like I don't think you guys would enjoy it nearly as much. It's fun doing Q&As like this. I much prefer something like this anyways, but I do plan on doing stuff on Twitch. I just know that on Twitch they don't really encourage stuff like this, so I don't know how much they would actually like it if I were to do something like this. I've heard stuff, like stuff from other people on Twitch that they're not too keen on it. They prefer people who play video games, but whatever. I'll figure it out in time. I'll figure it out. All right, what else? Okay, here's a question. Xbox One or PS4? PS4, to be honest. I've been like a Sony kid for a really long time, since PS1. Aw, choir dude. Thank you. That's really nice of you. Okay, I've got to go and get up a few hours. This was a great live stream. Looking forward to it. Thank you, Matrix. It was really, really nice having you here. Thanks so much, and I will talk to you very soon, okay? Jesus, there's a lot of people messaging like, oh, stop. Christian, thanks so much for joining. Really appreciate it. Rizzy, is that so, eh? Okay, I'm gonna have to look into that a bit more. I definitely want to do like more like talk show type streams and things like that. If you guys are interested in watching that, I'd love to expand in terms of this and in terms of streams and stuff. So we'll see. We'll see how it goes. I'll look into that and we'll see. This channel on Sharp Objects hits your top goal. This channel is really insightful and really well put together. Aw, Vivi, thank you. That's really sweet of you. That's really awesome. You guys, like all of you guys, are just really awesome. You're like super supportive and I couldn't ask for more. Sometimes I'm a little dumbfounded by it because I'm not used to this kind of encouragement. I'm the kind of person where I do definitely need like encouragement, because I don't always feel like I'm good enough or I'm doing well enough. That's why I keep trying to up myself all the time. I'm a perfectionist, and if I don't feel like I'm doing well enough or I'm not getting the kind of comments or critiques that I feel I need, it's a little disconcerting for me. Like, I'll still do stuff anyways, but it's always nice to be able to have that. So that's just means the world to me. Thank you. Okay, Forrest, oh my god, Forrest, I haven't seen you in forever. I hope you've been well. I was thinking about Valkyrie Profile Sumeria for the PS2. Have you ever played it before? And if you have, what do you think of it? I actually haven't. I haven't played any of the Valkyrie Profile games. I remember when I was like 16, I had a choice between Valkyrie Profile on the PS1 for $40 and Chrono Cross Black Label, and I was an idiot and I went for Chrono Cross. I love Chrono Cross. It's like one of my favorites, but at the same time, Valkyrie Profile, $250+. No, it was bad. it's sad to think about, but no, I haven't played any of the others, unfortunately. I want to, but not yet. Yeah, Devil Burning, it is the business inquiry email. Just feel free to send there, okay? It costs nothing to be supportive or your actions that are hurting other humans. Thank you, TJ. That really means a lot to me. Yeah, I just am hard on myself. That's why I push myself to the limits, because I just like, I want to do better. I want to be the best I can be. So it's all about, you know, us supporting each other at the end of the day. I think we're all part of a community, you know, we're all part of the same community. That's why I like doing these live streams in particular, because I don't always get to comment on videos because there's just like, it's such high frequency, I can't keep up. But at least here I see the comments live, and I can reply to them as quickly as possible, right? So that's super important to me. No, I haven't heard of Deadly Silence. But I do try to watch your videos. Aw, thanks, Forrest. Yeah, I really hope that you can get back into videos soon too. I really enjoyed watching your videos, and I remember when I started and I was watching your videos, and you really inspired me. You and Shinkai reviews, actually. So I'm just like, ah, so many memories. It's been a while. It's been a while, but it's one of those things where I don't know. You guys are awesome. I'm just like so bashful. I'm just like, oh, I don't know. I'm just so happy to have all of you here. Whether you are a newer subscriber or an older subscriber, it doesn't matter. You guys are all really wicked. Just the fact that you offer the kind of support that you do. So thank you. Yeah, thank you, Jimmy. I really appreciate that. Usually when it comes to older games, I do like top videos, like top tens or top fives, but I do want to do more like reviews of retro games and things like that because I talk about them enough as is, especially like just all around. I talk about them, just not in review format. So I definitely will. I really appreciate that. And thank you so much for joining this stream. That was really wicked of you. Cookie time. I could totally use a cookie right now. Yes, let's all hold hands and sing. Alan, you are a genius. No, I've never heard of the game Darkest Dungeon. Yay, we're all getting along. Yay. I'm so happy. Yeah, it really does. I know that for a while there, I was like super depressed. I was just like, I feel like every video I was releasing was just so depressing. There's always something where I would just reflect back on something that made me feel sad or unhappy with my life. And I don't really have a need to feel that anymore. I'm pretty happy overall. I think it's just more that this has been a really tiring week for me, and so I'm feeling a bit on the fatigued side. And I'm trying to figure out how exactly I'm going to balance my schedule out and how I'm going to be able to, work in an office a couple days a week, work retail a couple days a week, and then release videos on two channels. But I think it's something I can do. It's just something I'll need to try and balance out as well, right? Really? RJ? I'm so sorry. Never heard. Favorite cookie? Peanut butter. Peanut butter cookies are good. Or white macadamia nut cookies. Those are delicious. Yeah, of course, TJ. Like everyone's gonna have their off and on days, right? I'm a pretty sensitive, emotional person. So like sometimes even if I act cool, even if I act like gracious and cool and calm and collected, not always. I'm pretty good at hiding that kind of stuff until the last minute, right? Yeah, clam it up. I'm so happy that hashtag is still being used. Nostalgic Dan was so great for putting that together. Okay. Okay, bye, Shinta. It was really nice having you here. Okay, guys, it's like past 3.5 hours now. I think I'm gonna head off. But thank you so much for joining this live stream. It was really awesome. This was a nice little preliminary celebration for 14K subscribers, which I'm like so close to. It's like in my grasp. But yeah, so I really appreciate you taking the time to watch this. It's been so awesome. And I just want you guys to know like how much I appreciate all of your support. However you're offering support doesn't matter, like it means so much to me. I can't ever possibly like express to you how much it means to me. So thank you. I hope you all have a good night, a good day, a good weekend. My next video will be my weekly vlog number 38. That's going to be happening on Sunday. And then if you want a little bit of a teaser in terms of videos that are coming up, I'm going to have my top 10 female video game characters of all time. So that's going to be split up into two parts, two fives. One of those is going to be released this coming week. I'm also going to have a review for the film that I've been mentioning all night, Girl Walks Home Alone at Night, this really nice Iranian vampire flick that I saw. I'm also going to be releasing my top 20 horror films of all time. That's going to be released obviously in four parts because I can really only fit like five in each if I wanted to be at like a decent time under 10 minutes. So those two reviews are going to be on Sharp Objects. That's my alt channel. If you want to check out my alt channel, you can see it in the details. But yeah, so on this main channel, I'll have top 10 female video game characters. I'm gonna have what else? I may have an unboxing coming up. I know my friend Carlos sent me a package, and I may or may not get it in time, which would be really nice. And what else? There's something else too. I know there's something else. See, I'm gonna look at my planner because my planner has everything in it. My live stream. I gotta release my Majora's Mask review soon, but I gotta wait until the embargo's ready. Ah, my monthly pickups, January 2015. I'm gonna be releasing that. And then, of course, my weekly vlog. Hopefully, I'll be able to do the. Oh, yeah. And then I have another review. I have my Tokyo Godfathers review for Satoshi Kon. That's going to be coming up on Monday. So there's a lot of videos coming up this coming week. And because you stuck around for so long, you got to hear all about them because I didn't tell anyone any of this earlier. So if you're here for this, you're extra special. But yeah, okay, I'm tired. Have a good night, guys. It was really nice being here. Thank you so much. And yeah, I will catch you all later. Peace. Ah, stop.